with Tulsa and East Carolina next. Welcome to ESPN's coverage of college football presented by 5-Hour Energy as part of Dick's Sporting Goods Kickoff Week. And today we welcome you inside Dowdy Ficklin Stadium in Greenville, North Carolina, the home of the Pirates of East Carolina. They lift the curtain on 2010 with a conference matchup against the Golden Hurricane of Tulsa. East Carolina with one of the better intros in all of college football. They've expanded the stadium to 50,000 that you'd swear there were 75,000 or 80,000 fans here today. Hi, everybody. Along with former Pitt quarterback John Congemi, I'm Mike Gleason. Great to have you with us. You look at East Carolina, two-time defending champions in Conference USA. But, John, not only is this a brand-new college football season, this is a new era. They lost a lot of players from that championship team, and they have a brand-new coaching staff.
Well, an old coach gets to come back to his alma mater and really lead this team to victory today. An old defensive back in Ruffin McNeil. He spent the better part of 10 years directing the defense at Texas Tech. He believes in old-school leadership. You win with blocking and tackling. Fundamentals override talent. His first football coach taught him that a long time ago, his father. He'll lean on that philosophy today, but he'll also lean on some playmakers on the outside to make it happen. And that's one is wide receiver Dwayne Harris, 2009 first-team Conference USA receiver, also the player of the year in special teams. This is the guy that caught over 1,000 yards in reception yardage last season. He'll be looking to do that again in this spread offense, Mike. And if there's one guy that can really break a game wide open, it's Dwayne Harris.
And you look at the Golden Hurricane of Tulsa. Back in 2007, they won 10 games. In 2008, 11 games. Last year, a bump in the road, 5-7 finish. But you look at the numbers of 07 and 08, they put up some staggering offensive numbers.
Mike, this is an offense that was a juggernaut in 2007 and 2008. They led the country in total offense, but they slid a little bit in 2009. And head coach Todd Graham brought in a new offensive coordinator in Chad Morris to try to jumpstart this offense once again. He'll look outside to wide receiver Damaris Johnson to make that happen. The all-purpose yardage leader in 2009 with an average of close to 225 yards per game. Mike, he has the ability to break a game wide open, and Tulsa has to find ways to get him the football. Johnson understands his role on the team, and that's to produce big plays.
Well, the student section here, known as the Boneyard, and these fans have anticipated this kickoff. They can't wait to see that Texas Tech type air raid offense. Tulsa, East Carolina, here from Greenville. We'll be back with the kickoff right after this.
You think if the game wasn't on today, we'd be out here around this grill?
Probably not.
Come on, man, you're not seeing the big picture. Football was created to make us grill. Look, how many letters in football?
7. 8.
How many letters in grilling?
7. 8.
What's the past tense of eat?
Eat it. 8.
8. Pretty strange.
Yes, you are.
Like a blast of hydration to your face. New Schick Hydro, the water-activated gel that hydrates your skin as you shave and lasts up to twice as long as ordinary strips, while 5 blades with skin guards smooth the skin to reduce irritation. It's the best shave for your skin. The new Schick Hydro, for your skin.
ESPN's College Football, brought to you by Kingsburg Charcoal. For more football fun, play Kingsburg's College Showdown on ESPN.com. And the new Schick Hydro, the only razor that's like a blast of hydration.
Welcome back inside Dowdy Ficklin Stadium in Greenville, North Carolina. You see the expansion of the stadium down in the end zone. Now it's a horseshoe as the Pirates of East Carolina look to defend that conference USA championship. And John Kangemi, they won the toss, and they're going to take the football.
Yeah, I think that's a smart decision by East Carolina. They want to come out and display this wide-open spread offense and try to put the points on the board first against a team in Tulsa that had difficulty scoring last season.
Kevin Fitzpatrick with the opening kick, and this football game is underway. It's a very short kick taken at the 28-yard line. The Pirates fumbled the football, and they will have possession close to the 35-yard line. And now, Dustin Lineback coming up to make the play there. We're going to find out the best-kept secret so far. Who's going to be the starting quarterback?
Well, you can't keep it any longer. It's going to be Dominique Davis. This is a guy that played for Boston College in 2008. He has major college experience, and I think that's why he gets the start. He's hungry because football was taken away from him. He's athletic. He makes good decision. A great leader outside for the offense for East Carolina.
Dominique Davis, 6'3", 215 pounds, played junior college last year, played in the national championship game. And the first give, they keep it on the ground. Jonathan Williams, and he's ridden out of bounds at about the 36-yard line. Dexter McCoy making the stop. As we take a look at the skill players for East Carolina, Williams, that's a story in itself. You take a look at some of the wideouts. Harris had 83 catches last year. Michael Bowman is a playmaker. And up front, Willie Smith, Corey Dowless, and DJ Scott starting a combined 82 games. That's where their strength is up front. Davis. This one's complete. Lance Lewis, a junior transfer from East Mississippi Community College, makes the play as we take a look at the Golden Hurricane defense up front. You see Audric Ray was penciled in at defensive end. He goes to the middle. Linebackers, the strength on the outside. And a very, very young secondary. But look at number 23, Jamad Williams. He was the starting tailback on this team when the week started. And the give is to Giovanni Ruffin. He gets his first carry of 2010. And, John, what about that? Williams, that's a great story because he actually asked if he could play defense.
Well, this is a guy that's been through a lot. He's been moved around quite a bit, and it's a good story in itself, so it's nice to see him out there early and being productive for this offense because they're going to be asked not only to wide open throw the football but establish some type of run, and you're going to depend on Ruffin and Williams to do that.
Second and nine now for Dominique Davis. Play action, fires, and a great defensive play intended for Justin Jones. But Charles Davis coming over to make the defensive stop. Davis in his sixth year after getting a medical redshirt.
Davis loves to move in that secondary, and he has great ball skills, and that's a tough throw, a small window for Davis to try to fit the football in there. A very physical guy on the outside is Davis, but great athleticism.
Four receivers on the field for the Pirates now, and Dominique Davis. Quarterback draw, and he picks up the first down. Gain of 10 on the play for Dominique Davis. Is that what gave him the edge over Brad Warnick and his mobility in the backfield?
Mike, I think it's his experience. I think it's the ability to go outside, make decisions, run a quarterback draw, know where the sticks are, and move those chains. And I think it was a great decision by Lincoln Riley, the young offensive coordinator who turns 27 today.
27 years old. That's
pretty
amazing,
young, huh?
Youngest coordinator, offensively or defensively, in the FBS. Davis fires back across the field. This one's complete to Dwayne Harris. And Harris, he dropped the football after being hit by a host of tacklers. Charles Davis again making the initial contact for Tulsa.
Mike, this is a throw you normally, you say no, 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 and then it's complete, and you say yes, great throw. You see the outside, on the outside receiver trying to climb the ladder, and Dwayne Harris, he almost made a great catch, but Charles Davis again coming in with the big stick from that secondary for Tulsa.
Davis making his 30th career start in the secondary. He was injured in the Oklahoma game last year, so they gave him a medical redshirt. Williams. Spins and weaves his way through traffic, stopped at the 40-yard line, a gain of 7 on the play to run Walker, the defensive end making the stop. There's Lincoln Riley, the 27-year-old
offensive coordinator coming over from Texas Tech. He said he's always known he had skills to lead, and now he's a chance to lead this offense after leading Texas Tech to that bowl game victory over Michigan State last year after Mike Leach was pushed to the sidelines.
Yeah, we had a great conversation with him yesterday. Only 27, turns 27 today, but a wealth of experience in those 27 years.
Todd Graham uses his first timeout, and when we come back, the Pirates are on the move.
New Smirnoff Premium Malt Mixed Drinks. A delicious explosion of cranberry and lime. And a real mixed drink taste worthy of a glass. 5.8% alcohol by volume. Please drink responsibly.
A real national pastime? Saving money. And like baseball, people love their stats.
I started bringing my lunch to work. $50 a week in my pocket.
Here's a good one. State Farm insures 40 million drivers, more than Geico and Progressive combined.
I save because I'm accident free.
Of course, with so many ways to save, including discounts of up to 40%, having that many customers shouldn't be a surprise. So ask a neighbor about State Farm. Then call an agent at 1-800-STATE-FARM or go online.
Sunday night NFL games and NFL Red Zone. Now everything football is everywhere. Only with Verizon. Rule the air.
College football in high definition is presented by Vizio. You're watching ESPN, new home of the Bowl Championship Series.
And it's good to see the BCS back with the ESPN family of networks. Opening drive for the Pirates of East Carolina here in 2010 as Dominique Davis now facing a third down and 4 yards to go. Davis lobs it up and it's batted away. Good defensive play that time by Lowell Rose, the UCLA transfer. Again, they were looking for number 88, Lance Lewis, the transfer.
Lowell Rose does a nice job of making a play on the football. A lot of times defensive backs wait and don't turn their head and try to pick up the football. That time, Lowell Rose did a nice job of picking up the football. He had a great week of practice, Mike, leading into this game. And he starts off nice on the outside against Lewis.
Punting situation now for the Pirates. Ben Ryan, a junior from Marshfield, North Carolina, getting his first punt. And it's a nice spiral kick, but this is going to hit the end zone. So the Golden Hurricane will open up their 2010 offensively from the 20-yard line. A 41-yard boot, a net of 21. As we take a look at Tulsa offensively, the skill position, Trey Watts, that is the son of J.C. Watts, the former Oklahoma quarterback. Damaris Johnson, as John said at the top of the show, leading the nation in all-purpose yardage. Trey Johnson with 24 touchdowns, 8 shy of the receiving record. And up front, Tyler Holmes there at the left tackle, 2-time Conference USA preseason first team. He was injured last year, missed 6 games. They come out with 5 wides. And the quarterback, G.J. Kinney, the junior from Gilmore, Texas, he was the leading passer and rusher, and I don't think they want him to lead in the ground game this year.
Mike, he was asked to do a lot in this offense last year. He has a wealth of experience and confidence in this spring and summer. They're trying to work on him staying in the pocket and not bailing so quickly, and I think you'll see that today. You'll see a lot of motion in this Tulsa offense from empty back to the backfield to try to run the football.
He picked up 5 on the play. Fires out in the flat, and this one's complete. And the fumble. It's on the carpet. at about the 27-yard line, and the Pirates are going to come up with the football. Emmanuel Davis, the all-conference cornerback.
Nice job by the Pirate defense on the outside, causing havoc in the backfield. The strip right away by Wes Pittman, and then Emmanuel Davis on the football. It's a clean throw to the outside, but a good strip by Pittman there with the right hand on the football. And then Emmanuel Davis, this guy has some swagger on the outside for the Pirates, and it gets this crowd into it early.
Well, Damaris Johnson is the guy who coughed up the football. And you talk about the expansion of the stadium. Davis says he can't wait to see himself up on that new Jumbotron. Davis, penalty flags are down, and he's looking for Dwayne Harris. It falls incomplete.
Holding. 76 on the offense. 10-yard penalty. First down.
That's Randy Smith, the referee. Dalton Falls, the center, called for the infraction. And you look at Tulsa, that first turnover, Todd Graham trying to turn things around from last season. The last two times they played East Carolina, they were decimated with turnovers.
You can't win games when you turn the football over at a high rate, and that's exactly what Todd Graham wants to stop today, is turning the football over.
All at the 37-yard line. They keep it on the ground. That's Jonathan Williams. Jonathan Williams busts to the outside, finds a lane, still on his feet. Touchdown! East Carolina. 37 yards for Jonathan Williams.
Jonathan Williams makes two people miss at the point of attack. He shows you his strength, and offensive coordinator Lincoln Riley says this is the most versatile and tough back I've ever been around. And that's saying a lot. He breaks tackles about the line of scrimmage, and then he runs right through on the outside. Lowell Rose, the cornerback, we talked about him earlier, having some adversity in life. No adversity today. He gets in for 6 points.
The transfer from Maryland, Michael Barber, gets his first kick through the uprights. And the Pirates, the two-time defending Conference USA champions, on top 7-0. Jonathan Williams, a local product from right here in Greenville. J.H. Rose goes 37.
What's your 2:30 feeling like?
Well, it's like my brain just stops working.
Feel fuzzy, groggy.
I can barely keep my eyes open.
So what do you do?
I used to get another coffee.
Yeah, coffee or soda.
Then another coffee.
But I switched to 5-Hour Energy.
Just one 5-Hour Energy.
The rest of the day, I'm great.
Zero sugar, only 4 calories.
I don't feel jittery. I'm in control.
It's me. Just a better, more awake me.
Gotta try 5-Hour Energy.
5-Hour Energy. Hours of energy now. No 2:30 feeling later.
Let me show you how to be a tough cornerback. Use those Nike Zoom Vapor Carbon Fly cleats to cover your man like shade. And use those Nike Vapor Jet gloves to bury your man in coverage. Now that you got that receiver on your island, you can keep him there for the whole game. But make sure you name your island. They call mine Revis. What's your last name?
Gilligan.
The Nike Vapor Carbon Cleat and Vapor Jet Glove at Dick's Sporting Goods. Better athlete, better team.
Does anyone else have to turn up the volume when they eat Wheat Thins? Someone needs to invent crunch-proof headphones. He will be surprised. Tim Parker, do you remember when you tweeted, does anyone else have to turn up the volume when they eat Wheat Thins? Someone needs to invent crunch-proof headphones.
Yes.
All right, well, guess what, pal? Straight from Wheat Thins.
No
lab.
Way.
We're gonna try this. Ready?
Okay.
That's a success. Let's roll. Bring it in. Come on, boys. Who's next?
ESPN's College Football is presented by 5-Hour Energy. Hours of energy now, no 2:30 feeling later. For more information, visit 5hourenergy.com. And in part by Dick's Sporting Goods. Every season starts at Dick's.
And welcome. to Greenville as the Pirates, the two-time defending champions in Conference USA. They watch Jonathan Williams scamper 37 yards for the touchdown, and the Pirates take the early lead.
Yeah, Emmanuel Davis sets it up by the fumble recovery, and then Jonathan Williams goes 37 yards. He ran through two, maybe three arm tackles at the point of attack, one about the 10-yard line, showing you how strong he is as a running back. He's a senior, 6'1", about 212. He's probably put on about 10 to 15 pounds. We're talking with Coach Ruffin McNeil yesterday, and he really likes what he sees out of Williams.
So Ben Ryan ready to kick off now for the Pirates. We'll talk more about Jonathan Williams and his career here. What a roller coaster ride it's been. One of the more interesting stories. Damaris Johnson, the deep back, and he will take it at about the 6-yard line. Finds a lane. Damaris Johnson, who led the country at all-purpose yardage, dragged down at the 45-yard line, a return of 38 yards, finally dropped down by Leonard Polk. Tomorrow night, catch a season-defining game for two top 10 teams as Kellen Moore leads the third-ranked Broncos of Boise State against Ryan Williams and 10th-ranked Virginia Tech. The All-State kickoff in the Capitol is part of Dick's Sporting Goods Kickoff Week on ESPN starting at 8 Eastern. College football is available on TV, online, and on your phone. Go to ESPN.com for more information. Boy, John, that's going to be a great football game. It's amazing. Kellen Moore's numbers as a starting quarterback for Boise State, just one loss.
Another fumble, Mike.
Last year, the Pirates were plus 11 in the turnover margin, and they lost nine starters on defense. Nine starters, so great start for the Pirates defensively.
Well, this has to be something of a concern for head coach Todd Graham and offensive coordinator Chad Morris. Coughing up the football early are going to give the Pirates a lot of opportunities. Thankfully, he was able to get on the football, but Trey Watts takes a stick in the middle of a pile. I'm not sure who in a white jersey got on it, but thankfully for the Golden Hurricane, they retained possession.
Kenny fires and overshoots his man, again looking for Damaris Johnson. Let's take a look at the Pirates defensively now. In 2010, again, they lost nine starters from last year's championship defense. Matt Milner, he's a redshirt freshman. Josh Smith, the only senior. Robert Jones is a sophomore. Marquis Powell, a sophomore. Linebackers, the outside, Wes Pittman, Dustin Lineback, both former walk-ons now starting. And in the backfield, Simmons and Davis, both first team, all-conference, USA. Coaching staff says they're probably the two best corners in this league, if not the country. This one's almost picked off. Marquis Powell, a sophomore from Troy, North Carolina, only goes 198.
Marquis Powell, if he could just catch this football, he may have some green grass and may run into the Pirate in the end zone. There's no one in front of him, and I'm not sure. Sometimes as a quarterback, you lose that underneath coverage, but Kenny lost Powell right in front of him, and thankfully for Tulsa, right now offensively, they don't turn the football over and give the Pirates instant field position again.
Michael Such, the former soccer player, the senior averaged almost 45 yards a punt last year. Deep man is Dwayne Harris. Harris standing at the 11-yard line. He takes it at the 9 and does not call for the fair catch, and he is dropped at about the 9-yard line. 43-yard punt, 2-yard return for Dwayne Harris. Ruffin McNeil in his first game as the head coach of the Pirates. Grew up in Lumberton, about 140 miles from here. 3-year starter, 2-time captain here from 1976 to 1980, played for Pat Dye. And, you know, John, they still talk about a hit he had in the opening game in 1977 against NC State.
Yeah, they do. He's one of those guys that's legendary, and Ruffin McNeil is a legend around here, and I know this is his dream job. I'm going to have to tease him, though, Mike, about those young pitchers. He looked pretty good back then. Not that he doesn't look good now. I don't want him to be mad. He fed us well yesterday.
12-yard line now for Dominique Davis. And they keep it on the ground. Jonathan Williams again, what the call. You know, I was talking about how Williams is such a good story. Now, at J.H. Rose High School here, John, two state titles, back-to-back 16-0 seasons. As a sophomore, he averaged 12 yards a carry, almost 12 as a junior, 2,800 yards, 39 touchdowns as a senior. But he's been injured, and he's been in the doghouse with Skip Holtz for years. In 2008, arrested three times. This is Williams with the ball. And he's going to be dropped inside the 10-yard line. Cornelius Arnick, the Sam linebacker, coming to make the stop. A loss of one on the play. But to continue that story, Mr. Williams meets Ruffin McNeil, and it's a whole different story. McNeil gives him another chance.
Well, actually, it's a heart-to-heart, and a couple times that Williams had to come into the office and talk to Coach McNeil, and I think they ironed everything out because this is a team, believe it or not, that follows Jonathan Williams' every move.
Davis, near side. This one's complete. And it's pulled in by Michael Bowman. Bowman, a junior from Wadesboro, North Carolina. Just two catches last year, but they say, boy, he's going to be a playmaker here.
Yeah, he's an undersized guy at 5'9", 165, but he's got his body in a little bit better shape now, ready to take the shots in the inside and then the outside. He's got the movement in and out of routes. Bowman needed to get about a yard and a half more. He didn't realize where the stakes were to move the chains on third down, so that punting unit will come in for the Pirates.
Needed 11, got about 10. And Ben Ryan, the junior, back to punt from the 5-yard line. There's Damaris Johnson back for the return. He had a touchdown last year and a long of 66. It's a low line drive kick, and this is Johnson. Puts his head down, drops just shy of the midfield stripe. He had the three longest plays for Tulsa last year. One on a touchdown reception, one on a kickoff return, one on a punt return. This one goes 13 yards after a 44-yard punt. 7-0 Pirates on top.
What is the new Sonic good? It's what's going on at Sonic right now. Like our new burger with a bigger, juicier, 100% pure beef patty. And it's getting our new better burger delivered right to your car by a friendly skating car hop. It's not just a burger, it's a better burger with a side of great service. It's new. It's better. It's the new Sonic good. Drive in and try our new Sonic loaded burgers, like the Western Chili loaded burger or the Spicy Southwest loaded burger.
Hey man, you coming to the draft tomorrow, right?
Of course, I'm the only one that knows how to pick a team around here.
Didn't you lose last year?
I can't be held responsible for that. Besides, this year, I'm gonna sit back and let the draft come to me.
All right, you're up again.
Hang on. I got another scout calling in from Europe.
Go, Rodrigo.
What happened with just letting the draft come to you?
ESPN Fantasy Football. Sign up today at ESPN.com.
Introducing the all-new Sobakawa Cloud Pillow, a pillow 300 years in the making, based on the traditional Asian buckwheat pillow. The Sobakawa Cloud is filled with over 10 million air beads, a virtual sea of clouds. It does three things no other pillow does. Gives adjustable support, cools your head, and never breaks down. We placed eggs on the bottom of these cylinders, filled this cylinder with feathers from an expensive pillow. This 10-pound weight crushes the feathers and smashes the eggs. In this tube, we have stuffing from a fiber pillow, and it offers little resistance. Then we tried memory foam, and the weight wins again. Now watch as the weight hits the air beads. They absorb the shock, and the eggs are safe. Order your Sobakawa Cloud Pillow for just $19.99. Call right now, and we'll double your order. You'll receive a second Sobakawa pillow and pillowcase for just the shipping and handling. But you have to call now.
To order your Sobakawa Cloud Pillow, call 1-800-921-0685. 1-800-921-0685. Call now.
Back in Greenville, where East Carolina has a 7-0 lead over Tulsa. Now, Tulsa, the last two times they played the Pirates, they have been turnover prone. And Ruffin McNeil's defense gets after it early. Here's what's transpired so far. Damaris Johnson coughed up the football. Emmanuel Davis, the first-team All-Conference USA cornerback, came up with it. Jonathan Williams, a local product from right here in Greenville, bounces outside, goes 37 yards for the game's first touchdown, and that's where we stand right now. Ruffin McNeil picked up the victory last year against Michigan State as the interim head coach of Texas Tech. McKinney, they keep it on the ground. This is Watts. Watts picks up the first down. Good run by J.C. Watts' son. You know, John, he's gone from like fifth string up to the starter here today. That's amazing.
It's a great story because no one really knew of him in the spring, and they were saying, who's 22? And they kept saying, well, that's Trey Watts. And all of a sudden, he's into the starting lineup because he has a great first step, a great knack of finding the hole in between the tackles.
Kenny. Good coverage. And he's going down at about the 40-yard line, picks up a half a yard, maybe a yard. Melvin Patterson, the middle linebacker, comes up to make the stop. Patterson, the former safety. Boy, a lot of great battles in camp for the linebacker spot all over this defense. And Brian Mitchell, the defensive coordinator, said, you know what? I inherited a guys that didn't have a lot of experience, but boy, they were good in the classroom, weren't they?
Good competition everywhere, especially in this secondary.
Five wides now. Kinney fires, and he has his man spun out of bounds shy of the 35-yard line. That's Charles Clay, who will probably be playing in the National Football League next year.
Charles Clay, a big body at 6'3", 235. This is a guy with 4.4 speed, and he's an H-back, maybe a fullback, but this is a crucial series for Tulsa, Mike. They have to find a way to move the chains and maybe get Charles Clay involved again on third down, because they've had great field position, but they really haven't done anything with it.
Well, here's your third down now, third and five for Tulsa. And they swing it out to Watts. Watts tries to cut it back, still on his feet, dropped at the 30. And it's another first down for the Golden Hurricane. They start to move the chains.
Terrific effort that time by Trey Watts. He was surely going to be tackled behind the line of scrimmage. Good pressure on the screen, but he eludes someone right there at the point of attack. It looked like Melvin Patterson, the middle linebacker, gets the missed tackle and moves the chains for the Golden Hurricane.
DJ Kenny, a junior from Gilmore, Texas. He keeps it, and he's still on his feet, dropped at the 22-yard line. Well, he was cut down hard. Picks up eight more now. Derek Blacknell making the stop defensively.
Mike, you had mentioned that GJ led the team last year in rushing, and offensive coordinator Chad Morris doesn't want him to do that because he doesn't want him to take shots like that at the end of the play. It's second and short. They want to let Trey Watts and other guys like Derek Hall and Douglas carry the football this year.
Out of the shotgun, they keep it on the ground in reverse. Here's Johnson. Damaris Johnson turns the corner, finds a lane inside the 10, 5, stopped at about the 1 yard line.
Damaris Johnson on the reverse.
A gain of 21 for Johnson. Finally, a wrestle down by Matt Thompson.
Tulsa has to find ways to get number three the football, get him involved. This time on the end around, just a little bit of a reverse. He had great blocking out in front. The captain, Clint Anderson, out in front, delivers a terrific block about the 7-yard line. It gets Tulsa knocking at the door.
And the Pirates of East Carolina call their first timeout here in the first half, so we're going to take a timeout. Golden Hurricane trying to turn around from last season. They're knocking on the door at the 1-yard line when we come back.
Managing a multi-million dollar investment fund. Drafting human rights policy for the United Nations. Preserving the best of America's past. Defending our nation from cyber threats. Building sustainable infrastructure in developing countries. Our students achieve the extraordinary every day. The University of Tulsa, forward thinking.
There is a new direction in North Carolina, pointing to breakthrough discoveries, cures for disease, new opportunities for education, guiding the next generation of leaders, pointing toward a more prosperous future and a better way of life for all of us. There is a new direction in North Carolina, and it points toward tomorrow. East Carolina University. Tomorrow starts here.
Back inside Dowdy-Ficklin Stadium, Greenville, North Carolina. Tulsa looking more like that team they were in 2007-2008. They keep it on the ground, and they score the touchdown. Alex Singleton getting the call. And the first touchdown goes on the ground, and that's where Todd Graham said they had to get back to establish the running game.
Just an unbalanced line by Tulsa. They have everybody lined up on the left side. It looked like ECU didn't adapt or didn't adjust at the point of attack, and that was too easy of a touchdown from 1 yard out.
Fitzpatrick on for the extra points and the equalizer. right down the middle of the freeway. So Tulsa puts together a nice drive, and they come back after opening up the drive with decent field position. And talking with the coaching staff, they had four tailbacks, and they said probably all four will play this afternoon, but the young man, Singleton, wasn't even on the list.
No, he wasn't on the list, but he did a nice job of just lowering those shoulder pads, running behind his pads in that big offensive line.
So we're tied up at 7-7. The NASCAR Sprint Cup Series heads back south for Labor Day weekend. Only two races remain for Jamie McMurray and Mark Martin to get off the bubble, back into the chase. The NASCAR Sprint Cup Series at Atlanta on ESPN tonight at 7:30 Eastern. Tied up at 7-7 as you take a look at the Golden Hurricane of Tulsa. And John, you go back to that 2007-2008 season. Tarion Adams had 1,500 yards rushing in 08, 1,200 plus in 07. And Todd Graham, the head coach, saying that's what we got to do, and we didn't focus good enough on defense last year, and we have to establish that running game.
And so his focus is going to be back on the defense, and that's why he brought in Chad Morris to be his new offensive coordinator, and he's really relying on that. And when they built this offense, Mike, way back when, Todd Graham said that I tried to build this offense and put everything in it that I hated to defend. And that's why it's so diverse, because they started with that premise and built this offense from there.
Fitzpatrick ready to kick. Dwayne Harris with three touchdown returns in his career all last season. Another short kick taken at the 20-yard line and driven out of bounds at the 30. And Ezekiel Pursuit with the return out of Ardrey Kell High School in Charlotte, a return of 10 yards. Chad Morris, 21-7 in his first 2 years. He won 10 games and 11 games, and a lot of missed opportunities, John, last year, but he said at the bottom line is we didn't get the job done.
Well, they didn't get it done, and they want to find a way to do it this year. And Chad Morris, you know, he had a goal to be a college offensive coordinator by age 40. Well, he's 41. He was pretty close, and he's doing a pretty good job today.
18 years in high school football, 16 as a head coach down in Texas. Pirates fire. This one could have been picked off, and Davis misses his man looking for Joe Womack.
So,
16 years as a head coach at Texas football, 6 championship games he played and won the title 3 times, but John, I think the 11 Texas Coach of the Year awards really speaks for itself.
Pretty special guy and a great leader. Everybody you talk to has nothing but great accolades about Chad Morris and how he is as a coach and how he develops his players.
Davis working on second down, comes to the near side. This one's complete. And it goes to Michael Bowman with his second catch of the afternoon. Jamon Williams, the former tailback, on the coverage defensively. Lake Travis High School back-to-back Class 4A state champion. Great resume there in Texas. And now his first game as an offensive coordinator. There he is, Garrett Gilbert, now the starting quarterback for the Texas Longhorns. And boy, he put up some monster numbers in high school.
Pretty good guy to have as your quarterback.
Davis. And Davis over the 50, run out of bounds at about the 47-yard line. Dominique Davis, the former Boston College quarterback, picks up 14.
Good decision by the experienced quarterback, and Davis gets a great block on the outside by Michael Bowman, number 22, out in front of him. Does a good job of a little shake and bake on the outside and then gets out of bounds to move the sticks again, and ECU's offense is rolling.
Davis looks, fires, finds his man Harris. Harris, 30. Inside the 30, dropped at the 27. So Harris, with 83 receptions last year, just shy of 1,000, picks up 21 more for the Pirates.
We talked about him in the open, the playmaker on the outside. He has a knack for getting open and catching the football. Great hands and a great strong throw to the outside.
And this one got going a little bit too quickly. That up-tempo was funny during
the
scrimmage recently.
67 on the offense. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Penalty goes against Grant Horner, the redshirt freshman out of Jacksonville, Florida. And he's probably has the least experience on an offensive front. A strong offensive front for the Pirates. But Ruffin McNeil was saying they had a scrimmage recently, and it was actually the officiating crew that was slow in getting the ball down. And they're working on that up-tempo offense.
They're going to use it to their advantage today.
Davis, 5 for 9 for 46 yards. They keep it on the ground. This is Williams. Puts his head down. Dropped at about the 26. 7-yard line, a gain of 5 on the play. They had him listed at 196. They say he's closer to 210, although he did lose some weight from last year. He was timed at a 4.37 in the 40-yard dash. Davis hooks up again, and this one's complete. Justin Jones. Jones, 6'8", 252-pounder, a redshirt freshman from Georgia, recruited as a tight end. He said, hey, with this new offense, I can play defensive tackle or wide receiver. I like scoring touchdowns.
He's going to be special on the outside with that size, especially in the red zone down here inside the 20.
Third and 5 from the 21-yard line now for the Pirates, a 7-7 ball game here in the 2010 opener.
Football.
And he's going to call a timeout. That'll be the second timeout used by ECU here in the first half, leaving them with one to go. So Dominique Davis, it came down to a game time decision. We talked with the coaching staff and they were very open here at East Carolina, except for the quarterback situation. They said, we do not know. And apparently it came down to game day as we take a look at Dominique Davis at Boston College.
I think it came down to leadership and experience and maturity, those types of things of being there and being able to deliver in high-impact games. He's done a nice job at Boston College. He started the last three games there in 08, including the ACC championship. He had great stats, 6 touchdowns, 741 yards. He threw a career-high 263 and a touchdown in the title game against Virginia Tech. So this is a guy, he's strong arm, he has good mobility, can move on the outside, can roll either way and still have velocity on the football. But I think it was his experience, Mike, and the decision making from inside the pocket.
And led BC into a bowl game against Vanderbilt, but then lost the job because of academics. And last year went to Fort Scott Community College. More on Davis after this play. Third down, 5 yards to go. There's the lob, and it's incomplete. They're looking for his number one receiver, Dwayne Harris. And John Flanders on the coverage defensively for Tulsa.
Nice job on the outside by Tulsa. It's been at least 2 or 3 times now in third down situations where they go man coverage, and Flanders on the outside does a great job of pushing Dwayne Harris. Didn't give him a lot of room to fit the football in there. Harris had no really room on the outside to give a nice target to Dominique Davis to float the football into.
There's Michael Barber with a 38-yard field goal attempt, his first as a Pirate. Michael Barber, who thought he won the job at Maryland last year before they headed to Cal, found out he wouldn't be kicking, so he transferred, and Ruffin McNeil back out in front after the 38-yard field goal by 3, 10-7 over Tulsa.
Good snap, good hold, and a nice boot for ECU. They really take advantage, and your head coach, Ruffin McNeil, fired up a little bit on the sidelines, taking that lead at 10-7 with 3:01 left to go in the first. And Mike, you like that they got points out of that drive. Yes, you want to come away with a touchdown, but this team found a way to put points on the scoreboard.
Ruffin McNeil, we mentioned the fact that he was a starting cornerback for 3 years here, 2-year captain. He was 18-1 at home as a player. Now his first game as the head coach of the Pirates of East Carolina in an expanded stadium. They opened the stadium back in 1963. Pirates beat Brian Piccolo and Wake Forest back in 1963. Now opening up 50,000 seat stadium here in Greenville.
Well, he loves what he does and he's glad to be here and he's excited about being here. He was able to really, what was important to him is getting his own staff together and building a village and running it like a village and a family. And you can tell that at practice. You can see his coaches, his players, when they're walking by him, they all come in and check in with him. Make sure, coach, you okay? And he says, no, are you okay? It's a big family here, and it's a maybe a little different setting than what they've had in the last couple of seasons. One might not be better than the other, but it's a different setting, and I think these kids, these young athletes, are really buying in to what he's selling.
Ben Ryan with the kick. This one's a short one, going to be taken at the 22-yard line. On the far sideline. It drops just over the 35-yard line. Ricky Johnson with the carry, 16 yards on the return. Renovation of Dowdy Ficklin Stadium. That's what the stadium looked like last year, the year they won the conference championship 2 years in a row, and the construction was underway, and this is what it looks like now as they close it in with a horseshoe look. 50,000, a 52 now capacity here, and another 10,200 with individual seats also placed in the stadium. It cost about $20 million, the renovation, as they continue to grow their football program. Kenny swings it out. The ball is complete. A lot of running room inside the 45-yard line. That's complete to Charles Clay. Now, Clay, you mentioned he's 235 pounds. He runs a 4-4. I'm talking with Todd McShay of ESPN. They said he could very well be a starting fullback in the National Football League in a couple of years.
And we're an H-back. He has the speed to get out in the open and create mismatches with tailback, H-back against the linebacker.
Kenny looks, fires downfield. Looked like he had an open man. That would be Thomas Roberson, the freshman. Emmanuel Davis, the cornerback for the Pirates, on the cover defensively for ECU.
Davis did a nice job that time on the young freshman wide receiver, really pinning him to the sideline. And J.G. Kinney trying to fit the football in on that skinny post. He'll come back on second and 10 and try to do it again.
His way, keeps those legs going inside the 35-yard line, dropped at about the 33. Robert Jones making the stop after a gain of 8 for Trey Watts.
Mike, the one quality that Watts has as a running back is his speed, but I think the one thing that wasn't really mentioned is the power, breaking tackles at the point of attack. Three purple jerseys had a chance to limit that run to about 2 or 3 yards, but Watts was able to get into a third down situation that's very manageable now for Kenny, the quarterback.
Third and 2.
Wouldn't rule out a quarterback run here as well, Mike.
And there it is. And Kenny picks up the first down for Tulsa. Maybe you should leave the booth and you should be an offensive coordinator.
Oh, I'd love to. I'd love to join Chad Morris on the sidelines or a young guy like Lincoln Riley. Hitch my wagon to him. But that's a nice job of that offensive line. A good surge on the right side by 72. Clint Anderson, the captain up front, doing a nice job. Now what I'd like to do is maybe take a shot at the end zone after that play action.
Kenny out of the gun. Play action. Avoids the rush and throws it out of bounds. Good pressure in there by Justin Dixon. And these fans here at ECU, they want intentional grounding. There's no doubt he was not outside the tackle box, and he not too many white shirts where he threw the football.
Intentional grounding.
There it is.
Number 4 in the offense. Tony's lost it down by the foul.
And Mike, the only reason I don't like the call is because he has people draped around him. You see the play action. Justin Dixon had the pressure in the backfield, but he's got people draped around him, so he's trying to throw the football around someone. Now, no one's near the play. There was a wheel route going to the outside, but anytime you're draped, you're twisting around, sometimes that defender can move the football or move your body, and you don't get an accurate throw. So that was a good effort, I thought, by Kenny, trying to get it around someone, but it results as a penalty.
And a loss of 9, so it's second and 19 now. Kenny comes back, firing, finds his man. It's Johnson inside the 30, slips a tackle. Had to get down to the 20-yard line. It looks like he's very close. A gain of 17 on the play for Damaris Johnson.
Just a small glimpse of seeing how dangerous you can be on the outside. This is a simple out route. 5-step drop after the shotgun, but one man misses on the outside. That's Emmanuel Davis, the corner. And you're scared in the secondary because he's got that speed. If you make one guy miss, he'll turn it into 6 points.
Johnson, 1,131 yards receiving last year. First time in school history. 1,000-yard receiver in back-to-back-to-back seasons. Kenny keeps it. Dives down to the 20-yard line. Melvin Patterson making the initial contact and the stop. His fourth tackle already here this afternoon, but Tulsa continuing to move the chains now.
Mike, I really like the way Chad Morris is calling this offense. We talked to him earlier in the week. He said he was going to move people around,
show a lot of motion and then motion back into the offensive backfield to try to create some confusion. Right now he's doing a good job of creating that confusion in the run game.
And they keep it on the ground. Again, it's Patterson wrapping up Watts inside the 20. Stopped at the 18-yard line. Justin Dixon, I stand corrected, made the stop for ECU. A gain of two then. We played 15 minutes. We'll take a timeout as the ECU Pirates trying to defend that Conference USA championship, leaded by three over Tulsa.
ESPN Sunday Night Baseball, Giants Dodgers, tonight at 8 on ESPN2.
It's like a blast of hydration to your face. New Schick Hydro, a water-activated gel that hydrates your skin as you shave and lasts up to twice as long as ordinary strips, while five blades with skin guards smooth the skin to reduce irritation. It's the best shave for your skin. The new Schick Hydro. Free your skin.
Where can a marketing administrator be a watercraft engineer? Where can a doctor serve his community while also treating patients around the world? Where can a student stay in school while expanding his education beyond the classroom? In the U.S. Army Reserve, you'll find the strength to develop new skills and gain an edge to get ahead. There's strong, and then there's Army strong. Visit goarmy.com/reserve.
See them boys? They got DirecTV. Been watching the Eagles game on their phones and laptops since they got here. No respect for their surroundings.
Ma'am?
Be right there, Shug. Here you go, fellas.
Only DirecTV lets you watch your game wherever you go. Call 1-800-DIRECTV.
This is Dr. Love!
And this is Dr. Pepper Cherry. It's got a little kiss of cherry flavor.
You want cherry? How about a little kiss?
Cherry, trust me, I'm a doctor.
You are out with friends. There's Jason. Wait, is that? That's Dave, and that's the Forbidden Dance. And you aren't about to keep it all to yourself. You've got an eye for detail. The Droid Incredible by HTC, exclusively at Verizon.
New Smirnoff Premium Malt Mixed Drinks. A delicious collision of blueberry and lemon. And a real mixed drink taste. Worthy of a glass. 5.8% alcohol by volume. Please drink responsibly.
We promised you an update from the U.S. Nationals. There have been no position changes in the last few cars in Top Fuel. This is number one and number two, Larry Dixon and Corey McLenathan on their run. They were blistering, but nothing has changed. And so we will be back at the conclusion of the game with final qualifying. And then on Monday, Labor Day, final eliminations on the air, 1 o'clock.
Welcome back to Greenville as we open up the second quarter along with former Pitt quarterback John Congemi. I'm Mike Gleason. East Carolina on top by 3-10-7, but Tulsa on the move. Good balance now with the rush and the pass with the Golden Hurricane so far.
Tulsa's done a nice job, 55 yards rushing and 52 passing for 107 total.
Kinney with a second and eight. Avoids the rush, but he's going down. Again, it's number five, Justin Dixon, making the stop. Dixon's been all over the place. He started the game as a backup defensive end. The redshirt freshman out of Smithfield, North Carolina.
Yeah, the first sack for Justin Dixon. He does a nice job of being relentless in that backfield. It looked like Kenny was going to get away, but almost ran right back into the arms of Justin Dixon.
Kenny Kenny was sacked 46 times last year, but keep in mind they had eight different starting lineups up front because of injuries. Third down. 14 to go. Kenny looks over at his offensive coordinator, Chad Morris.
Looks like, Mike, it's going to be man coverage, so you should have a nice window to throw to.
Trips to the bottom of your screen. And Tulsa charged with a delay of game penalty. Last year, they averaged about 48 and a half yards a game on penalties. But again, we go to the top of the broadcast. You look at 2008, almost 47 points a game. And last year, that dropped to 29. That's a big discrepancy.
And that's the job of Chad Morris, the offensive coordinator and quarterback, G.J. Kinney, trying to find a way not to take penalties like that to back you not out of good field position, but possibly out of field goal range. So that's a penalty you don't want to take.
Third and 19, ball off the 29-yard line. Kinney looks, fires, and it's incomplete. Good coverage by the Pirates, some miscommunication. Threw to the inside or the outside instead of the inside.
Yeah, he's trying to go to the outside. It looked like great coverage by the Pirates secondary. Morgan on the outside on Ricky Johnson. There was no room to throw the football. Now with that penalty, Mike, of the delay of game, a lengthy field goal attempt.
Kevin Fitzpatrick now on the attempt a 46-yarder. He was 13 of 14 last year. And this one's blocked. And the Pirates will leave it alone at the 20-yard line. So the Pirates, plus 11 last year on the turnover margin. They have a fumble recovery and now a blocked field goal.
Boy, a nice job by the special teams, and it's not a happy sight on the Tulsa sideline. Looked like a pretty good hold, but a low kick. Josh Smith, number 91, gets in the middle, and Todd Graham just shaking his head. Nothing's going right offensively right now to try to tie the game at 10. You get a penalty of a delay of game, you get a sack, and then big number 91, Josh Smith, putting that left hand up there to block it on special teams.
So Dominique Davis and company now with the football and the lead after Tulsa is moving down the field. And Davis, he's going down. Not too many sacks for ECU last year. They were only sacked 12 times. Seven of the last 10 games, they were sack-free. That's pretty impressive. Coming in, Tanner Antle from his outside linebacker spot to pick up the sack.
We've seen the ECU defense cause some turnovers early in this game and really flip the field position battle over. Right now, Tulsa has to do that defensively. Try to find a way to turn the football over.
Williams on his feet, dropped just shy of the 35-yard line. Jamad Williams with the carry, a gain of seven on the play. We're in Greenville, North Carolina, inside Dowdy Ficklin Stadium, home of the Pirates of East Carolina, the two-time defending Conference USA champions, as they open up against conference foe Tulsa. Along with the former Pittsburgh quarterback John Congemi, I'm Mike Gleason. Great to have you with us as the Pirates face a third and four now, holding on to the three-point lead. Davis just fires it up there, and a lot of contact, penalty flag down. Again, the intended receiver was Lance Lewis. Lowell Rose, the transfer out of UCLA, on the coverage. And there was some pushing and shoving going on.
Well, a lot of grabbing on the outside, and most of it being done by Lowell Rose. He got the jersey just in the back that time of Lance. Clearly pass interference. That almost was a nice catch by Lewis down there on the side.
Pass interference. 88 on the offense. That penalty's declined. Fourth down.
Well, that's going to bring up a punting situation for Ben Ryan. Now, keep in mind ECU, all the players they lost last year. One was the punter, Matt Dodge, who averaged just under 46 yards a punt. And he's now with the New York Giants. But they're going to go for it early in the second. Fourth and four. Holding on to a three-point lead. How surprising is this, John?
Mike, I don't understand how this isn't pass interference defensively. It looked like Rose had the jersey of Lewis Lance
right
on the outside right there. And
right
I thought
there.
That was the penalty initially. And then he almost makes an acrobatic catch. So I thought it was just clear-cut pass interference against Tulsa.
Lewis must have been guilty of the infraction before that hole. So it goes against Lewis and ECU, and now Ryan's on to punt.
Well, I don't agree with that one.
Maris Johnson averaged 14.2 on punt returns last year. One of the best in the country, takes this one at the 18-yard line. Johnson, he's quick as a bullet over the 30, dropped at the 32-yard line. 47-yard punt, a 14-yard return by Damaris Johnson. Tulsa will have the football when we come back, trailing by a field goal, 10-7 to the Pirates.
Every day, 36 kids learn that they have cancer. Over the last 12 years, Hyundai's Hope on Wheels program has raised more than $14 million to help find a cure. In fact, your local Hyundai dealer makes a donation for every car sold. Of course, you don't have to buy a Hyundai to make a difference. Just visit HyundaiHopeOnWheels.org to help and give a little hope, no matter what wheels you drive.
And now I'll turn it over to the Gecko.
Ah, thank you, sir. As we all know, GEICO has been saving people money on RV, camper, and trailer insurance, as well as motorcycle insurance. Ah, sorry. Technical difficulties.
What about this?
What's this one do? Maybe that one.
Okay, let's keep rolling. We run motorcycle insurance?
Take 15 minutes to see how much you could save on motorcycle, RV, and camper insurance.
Cheeseburger.
You're watching ESPN, new home of the Bowl Championship Series.
And welcome back to sunny Greenville, North Carolina. There's the numbers with 12:38 to go before halftime. East Carolina on top, 10-7, both coming in with the spread offenses. You know, you talk with Todd Graham, the head coach over at Tulsa. He says, you know what, our spread is a lot different than what they had at Texas Tech.
It is, and they want to try to run the football out of that spread. They want to try to get that identity so it's just not a reliant offense on the passing. But I thought both quarterbacks have done a nice job. Dominic Davis has done a nice job throwing the football outside, and Kenny's done a nice job of distributing the football. He's been under duress a little bit lately, but that offensive line has to keep him upright, keep him in the pocket so he can deal from it.
Well, that last graphic, very balanced between these two teams so far here on opening day. Kenny caps it and decides to fire it down to Ricky Johnson, the sophomore, and a good coverage that time by the Pirates. A loss of one on the play. Again, number 38, Emmanuel Davis, the junior.
Mike, Emmanuel, I've been impressed with these corners. They've done a nice job on both sides with Simmons and as well as Emmanuel Davis, two guys that are experienced in that defensive secondary for the Pirates.
Kenny now 6 of 10 throwing the football for 51 yards after the loss of one. Kenny comes back, fires, has his man. He's driven out of bounds just shy of the 35-yard line. Charles Clay on the receiving end picks up 3. Emmanuel Davis again defensively. You get back to the corners, a lot of zone under Skip Holtz, more man-to-man. And last year they played field and boundary, or wide side and short side. Now they're just playing left to right.
Yeah, and I think it really bodes well for both of them. They get accustomed to where they're at on the field. They can use their technique on the right side and keep it there the whole game. But right now there's a tough task at the bottom of your screen down here. The playmaker on the outside is Johnson.
5 defensive backs. Kenny 2 for 4 on third down conversion so far, trying to set up that screen, and it's sniffed out nicely by the Pirates. That'll bring up another punting situation.
Good defensive stand that time by the Pirates. Nice pressure in the pocket. Kenny had really nowhere to look for the football. He's trying to run a screen to the short side, and just four and five purple jerseys led by Justin Dixon on the pressure. Dixon, we've said his name two, three, four times this afternoon and trying to get some answers on the sideline, his coordinator and quarterback.
Michael Such, the senior, back to punt at the 20-yard line. Dwayne Harris scanning at his own 25-yard line for East Carolina. End-over-end kick, taken shy of the 35, and here comes Harris. And he thought he had some running room. Good coverage by Tulsa. Jadarian Douglas, the running back, comes up to make the stop. A 32-yard punt, a return of three. And we'll step away with 11:36 to go before halftime. It's still 10-7, Pirates by three.
Spicy chicken sandwich, now at Chick-fil-A.
Most car commercials tell you what to think. In this one, people told us what they think about Hyundai, uncensored.
Nice.
Hey.
I like this one a lot.
It passed my test. I want this car. What kind of car is it?
Hyundai.
Hyundai, like Sunday.
That's right, Hyundai, like Sunday.
You got it. Now get one, like the 2010 Genesis. It comes with Hyundai Assurance, including America's best warranty. And now, for a limited time, you can lease the 2010 Genesis for just $399 a month at your local Hyundai dealer.
John Mapes is 42, mortgage, married, two great kids. He wants to protect his family with a $500,000 term life insurance policy. What do you think it'll cost him? $100 a month? $60? $40? Actually, none of the above. John can get a $500,000 policy from a highly rated insurer for under $25 a month. His secret? SelectQuote. SelectQuote is impartial. They'll search the pick of insurers like these to give you a choice of your best prices. SelectQuote has great savings on term life for women, too. John's wife, Carrie, can get a $500,000 policy for under $16 a month. SelectQuote has helped make term life insurance affordable for hundreds of thousands of people since 1985. How about you? Just call this number or visit SelectQuote.com.
Call 1-800-207-1810.
ESPN's College Football, brought to you by Chick-fil-A. We didn't invent the chicken, just the chicken sandwich. And Kingsford Charcoal. For more football fun, play Kingsford's College Showdown on ESPN.com.
Back in Greenville, we talked about the expansion of Dowdy Ficklin Stadium, but it doesn't stop there. You saw the softball field, a beautiful edifice over there at the baseball diamond, new soccer fields, a new track being implemented into this campus. And boy, East Carolina and Terry Holland, the athletic director, very aggressive as far as pushing this athletic department forward. Davis fires, and he has the surfer. I say that, long blonde hair. Andrew Bodenheimer, the sophomore from Clemens, North Carolina. Marco Nelson on the coverage. They picked up 18 on the play on his first catch.
Boy, another nice throw as well. Strong arm by Davis.
There's Williams again bouncing to the outside. And he was off to the races if they hadn't grabbed his shirt tail. That's Terun Walker, the junior college transfer and defensive end, finally just grabbed onto his shirt and dragged him down.
What you like about that run? That was about a 3 or 4 yard loss that Jonathan Williams turned into about a 4 yard gain. He did an excellent job of keeping those legs going. And the added weight and the weight in the right places have really benefited his running style.
Second and six. Number 17, Dwayne Harris. Dominique Davis first saw Dwayne Harris on television. They played Virginia Tech in Charlotte, and they beat Tech 27-22. He was sitting in Boston thinking, boy, that number 17, he's good. Didn't know his name at the time, but he said he is thrilled to play with Harris here at East Carolina.
Well, I'm sure he wants to look at him on third down right here to try to get this conversion and keep this drive going. Harris has been had a lot of success on the outside today.
Third and six, Pirates holding on to the narrow three-point lead, 10-7. Davis fires and he overshoots his man. That is Harris. So Dominique Davis, that's probably the worst mistake he's made so far here early on.
That time, Dominique Davis, no one could have been more wide open than Dwayne Harris, and no one feels worse than Dominique Davis because all he had to do was catch and throw, and that's a first down because Harris did a nice job of going and getting enough yards that would have been a first down, just turning around to catch it. And Riley, the offensive coordinator looking on the sideline, knows that he missed one right there.
Lincoln Riley, the eyes in the sky for Mike Leach at Texas Tech. Now the offensive coordinator decide to go down and be on the sidelines. How surprising was that?
Well, I think it was a little surprising. He wants to look at those guys in the eyes and let them know what he thinks.
Ryan's punt rolls into the end zone. And a good effort there by the Pirates, but they can't down it. A 40-yard punt, a net of 20. Don't forget, tomorrow night, catch a season-defining game for two top 10 teams. Kellen Moore, the Broncos of Boise State, ranked third in the country, go up against Ryan Williams, and 10th-ranked Virginia Tech. The All-State kickoff in the Capitol as part of Dick's Sporting Goods kickoff week on ESPN tomorrow, 8 Eastern. College football is available on TV, online, and on your phone. Go to ESPN.com for more information. Should
Mike,
be a great one.
How about those numbers for Kellen Moore? 39 touchdowns, only 3 interceptions. Just a terrific year, and Ryan Williams can run with the best of them.
And this one's complete. Kinney finds his man. Charles Clay again with the catch. Charles Clay comes in with 31 touchdowns in his career, and they like to run him as well as put him out as a pass receiver. Last year, 63 carries, 39 receptions for 5 touchdowns. He's had 5 100-plus receiving games in his career. Big, big player will probably play on Sundays. They're coming up. Inside handoff goes for 1 or 2. Trey Watts with the carry.
Mike, not a lot of running room inside the tackles today for Trey Watts, but they're trying to establish the running game. This is exactly what Chad Morris, the offensive coordinator, wants to do. Take some pressure off Kinney, the quarterback, run the football, and hopefully that'll loosen up that coverage in the secondary.
Nowhere to go, and Kinney's going down again. Marquis Powell, second sack of the afternoon for the Pirates. Pirates had 28 of those last year in 2009.
Kinney wanted to throw the football over the middle to his receiver, Trey Johnson, but Johnson hit behind the linebacker, and that allowed the right defensive end, Powell, to come in and make the play.
Loss
good job. Good pressure in the pocket.
Loss of 2 now. 4 receivers on the field for the Golden Hurricane. Kinney fires down the middle, finds his man. It's complete. And Jameel Owens, the 6'3", 228-pound sophomore transfer from Oklahoma, picks up 27 on the play, and he beats Emmanuel Davis on the play.
That's a big-time throw over coverage. A great job of putting enough air and velocity at the same time on the football. Just a small window to fit that football in, but a nice job there on the play.
Well, that time Roberson with the catch, and Travis Simmons coming up to make the play defensively. So the Pirates weren't about to be burned back-to-back plays. Inside 8 minutes now before halftime. Second and 14 for the Golden Hurricane. Kinney looks left, then right, starts running, fires it downfield at the 30-yard line. Damaris Johnson on the receiving end. Derek Blacknall in the coverage. Gain of 17 more for Tulsa.
Mike, Kinney's starting to feel it a little bit. This is great job by the quarterback, having that clock in his head. He's thinking about tucking it, but his eyes never left the secondary. A good job on the outside by Johnson, catching the football, getting what he can, and then getting out of bounds. But a better job by Kinney, just having that quarterback clock in his head. He never took his eyes from downfield.
Johnson on the carry, turns the corner. He's got some room. 10-5, dives for the pylon. Did he make it? Yes, touchdown to Maris Johnson. Number one in the country in all-purpose yards. Last year in 2009, goes 31 for the touchdown, his first in 2010.
Mike, you can't teach this at the end of this run. This speed in the burst and the will to get in the end zone, just a terrific job by Damaris Johnson. We talked about his all-purpose yards, but he can make plays from anywhere.
And 13-10. And boy, Todd Graham can't be happy now. Charles Clay with the carry. They tried to go for two, and the Pirates weren't buying it. Boy, he ran into a wall.
Pirates staying at home. They did a nice job of preventing. Looked like Charles Clay to go off the left side on that fake extra point.
Damaris Johnson goes 31, and Tulsa has the lead.
You think if the game wasn't on today, we'd be out here around this grill?
Probably not.
Come on, man, you're not seeing the big picture. Football was created to make us grill. Look, how many letters in football?
Seven.
Eight.
How many letters in grilling?
Seven.
Eight.
What's the past tense of eat?
Eat it.
Eight.
Eight. Pretty strange.
Yes, you are.
New Smirnoff Premium Malt Mixed Drinks. A delicious collision of blueberry and lemon. And a real mixed drink taste worthy of a glass. 5.8% alcohol by volume. Please drink responsibly.
It's the Fusion Pro Glide Challenge.
Woo!
Hey, man, how you doing?
How's your shave?
Kind of like tugging and pulling.
See how shaving can cause irritating tug and pull?
That's why Gillette's introducing the revolutionary new Fusion Pro Glide.
It glides, like, literally.
Now Fusion Pro Glide has been engineered with Gillette's thinnest blades ever, so it glides for less tug and pull. Turn shaving into gliding and skeptics into believers. New Fusion Pro Glide. And warm up before you shave for incredible comfort with new Pro Series Thermal Scrub.
With the new Build Your Own Omelette from Denny's, you can make your own omelette any way you like spinach, tomatoes, and pepper jack cheese, or Swiss cheese, ham, and jalapeno peppers, or bacon, avocado, cheddar cheese, pico de gallo, prime rib, fire-roasted peppers and onions, chorizo, American cheese, sausage.
Every day, 36 kids learn that they have cancer. Over the last 12 years, Hyundai's Hope on Wheels program has raised more than $14 million to help find a cure. In fact, your local Hyundai dealer makes a donation for every car sold. Of course, you don't have to buy a Hyundai to make a difference. Just visit HyundaiHopeOnWheels.org to help and give a little hope, no matter what wheels you drive.
Ryan Burr in studio with your Taco Bell update. The MEAC and the SWAC challenge over on ESPN, Delaware State versus Southern. Fourth quarter, we pick it up. Corey Cushing Berry. For Southern, 54 yards, stutter steps, and look at him go up the sidelines. He's gone. That broke open a four-point game. Southern now by 10, 37-27. Mike and John.
All right, thanks a lot, Ryan. Here we have a 13-10 game, and Todd Graham surprised everybody in the stadium, I think, by going for two, and they didn't get it.
Yeah, they didn't get it. They gamble. They get the lead at 13-10, but it was a terrific job by their offense and really moving that football down the field and getting that offense into the end zone. It was a seven-play, 80-yard drive. It took up 2 minutes and 39 seconds, a 31-yard run by Johnson, and it was set up a Kenny to Johnson pass for 17. I thought Kenny looked excellent in that drive, throwing the football, moving around, using his legs and his athleticism to buy time and get Tulsa back in this game.
Kevin Fitzpatrick with another kick and another short one, trying to keep it away from Dwayne Harris. This one's taken at the 25-yard line. And so the Pirates will have it up over the 35. A Dustin Lineback, who's been very active on special teams, picks up 10. Now there's the touchdown by Damaris Johnson. He goes 31 yards, dives into the end zone, and they wasted no time going for two.
Well, they did a nice job on the end around. He hit full speed before he broke the tackle box, and Blackwell has an excellent angle but just doesn't believe he could get there. And I think Johnson surprised him with his speed and his burst and his effort of getting up into the air.
So now the Pirates are working from behind, trailing by three. Davis fires the ball, it's popped loose, and it's It's ruled an incomplete pass. A good defensive play. Bodenheimer, the intended receiver, and there's Davis on the play defensively.
Trying to fit the football into a tight spot. That's great coverage by Flanders, the cornerback, and a big stick coming from the inside in Charles Davis. A nice job by corner and safety.
Davis keeps it himself now, tries to cut up, and again, good defensive play over the 40-yard line. But Dexter McCoyle coming up from that free safety spot, but Davis picks up six. Good open field tackle by McCoyle, though.
Yeah, good job. You have to tackle in space if you're Tulsa or East Carolina when you run against these spread offenses, and they do a nice job of, on both sides defensively, tackling in space. That's a big job, and you have defensive backs that come up and can do it.
McCoyle, 13 tackles his freshman year against the Pirates of East Carolina. And a timeout is going to be called on the field.
Might be procedure up at the top, Mike.
The penalty flag, that's right, dropped at about the 42 on the top of your screen. Randy Smith, the referee, the Conference USA officiating crew, they'll push it back. Now the ball at the 37.
East Carolina offensively has to get back and try to establish some rhythm, and that rhythm was found earlier with Davis going outside.
And they go to the middle. This one's complete. Good concentration. Justin Jones, the big 6'8", 252-pounder. They say, boy, he can be murdering this spread on linebackers over the middle.
He can be as good as he wants to be, and with that size, he just posts up on the inside. And that takes a lot of courage going inside if you bobble it once to really take a look at that football and secure it for the catch.
Just shy of the first down marker. So he may be 6'8", 252 yards or 252 pounds, but Tulsa stopping him from getting to the first down territory. It's going to be fourth and short after the measurement. That short. So, John, what do you do? There's 6:16 to go. Fourth down, you're down by three.
I think Papa Ruff is sending in the big boys. They're going to go for this.
Ruff and McNeil. Todd Graham. Lincoln Riley. 27 years of age as of today, the youngest offensive coordinator in the FBS. Davis over the 45, had to get just to the 46, and it's going to be a first down for East Carolina.
Davis with that big body at 6'3", 215 pounds, all he needs is a little bit of a line surge, and that's all he got was a little bit. I thought Tulsa did a nice job of coming around and winning that battle at the line of scrimmage.
So but Giovanni Ruffin come in late, give a little push.
Yeah, he did. That'll help.
Inside 6 minutes now out of the shotgun. Here's Williams breaking to the outside. And a nice job by Tulsa stringing this one up. A gain of three on the play for Williams. Cornelius Arnick, the linebacker, making the stop for Tulsa.
Well, defensive coordinator Keith Patterson says you win this conference when you can play the best defense. And right now, this Tulsa defense is running around this football field.
And Todd Graham saying that last year probably didn't give enough focus to the defense like they had in years past. Davis looking, firing, and overshoots his man at the 10-yard line. And the intended receiver that time was Deion Arrington. That would have been his first catch. A good pressure by Tanner Antle, one of the outside linebackers.
Yeah, coming from the backside. I thought East Carolina did a pretty good job in the quarterback just flushing himself to the right side with the pressure was Antle. But the pressure coming from behind, Davis was lucky to get that football away and not take the sack.
So the Pirates facing another third down situation, third and seven from the 49-yard line, trailing by three. By 15 to go. As his man, it's complete. And a nice job of shaking the tackle. That's Joe Womack, a gain of 12. Womack. The gym rat, as they call him.
Mike, we were just applauding this defense for open field tackling. That time, Charles Davis misses the tackle. That's the fourth or fifth tackle in the open field that they have not been able to get the fourth one.
There's Harris now, the other side. looking for a lane. Keeps those legs churning down to the 30-yard line with 4:51 to go. Nine more for the Pirates after the completion.
Pirates starting to get a little bit more pace in this offense, and that's what you need. Once you've got a defense on their heels, try to get up to the line of scrimmage, call plays, and be successful with your offensive pace.
And the whistles, so we're going to have a clock stoppage here. Lincoln Riley, the offensive coordinator, said, I don't care if we run, I don't care if we pass, as long as we win. What is he seeing now? It seems like they're really opening up the passing game.
Well, I think the pace, and that's why Tulsa calls a timeout there, and Keith Patterson and head coach Todd Graham for Tulsa, they call a timeout because Lincoln Riley in this offense, especially the quarterback, Dominic Davis, starting to get a little rhythm, a little flow in this offense. So right away, the Golden Hurricane want to put a stop to that, and the best way to do it is call a timeout, get your troops over, talk about what you want to do defensively.
ESPN2's coverage of Major League Baseball and the hunt for October continues tonight on Sunday Night Baseball as Buster Posey and the Giants take on bitter NL West rival, the Los Angeles Dodgers, led by Andre Ethier. Sunday Night Baseball, presented by Taco Bell, is part of the Hunt for October, presented by Lee Jeans on ESPN2 and ESPN3.com tonight at 8 Eastern. 2010 opener for the Pirates. They beat this Tulsa team 2 years ago in the Conference USA Championship game. During that time, of course, Ruffin McNeil was still with Texas Tech. Last year, this Pirate team moved to the Conference USA Championship game again and outscored Case Keenum and the Houston Cougars 38-32. And right now, trailing Tulsa by 3.
He's got him.
And this one's going to go for a touchdown. Lance Lewis, his first touchdown as a Pirate. They say this young man could be a very, very special player the next 2 years here.
Over Marco Nelson. There was a penalty offsides defense. The Pirates will decline it. Nice job by Dominic Davis, just putting some air under the football, and that'll get the student section going. Offside, bottom of the screen right there. They declined the penalty on Walker, and Davis, just all he had to do, had perfect protection, just catch the football and put it up.
Michael Barber, his second extra point of the afternoon to go with a field goal. Lance Lewis, the junior out of Concord, played last year at East Mississippi Community College on the receiving end of a 30-yard strike.
Well, Davis makes it look easy. Really no pass rush to contend with. And then Lewis for his first touchdown. And you think the guy that's been on the sidelines pretty excited? I think he is.
Dominic Davis, his brother, the tight end for the Chicago Bears, probably at home watching this game. And Dominic Davis says, I'm ready to be the starting quarterback, even though the coaches did not announce it until game time. He said, after the first scrimmage, I thought I was ready to go.
Well, I think the coaches had an inkling. They just didn't want to share it with us. And I'm glad they didn't, because it keeps the, you know, the team probably knew, and that probably set well with them, because this is a guy that had football taken away from him, and he gets the crowd into it. They've done a nice job offensively of spreading the wealth. Lincoln Riley's done a nice job of using Jonathan Williams, getting Lance on the outside involved, their playmaker, Dwayne Harris. But their quarterback, the most important position on your team, you got to have the guy pulling the trigger, knowing where he wants to go with the football, and that's Dominic Davis.
Well, when Ruffin McNeil was named the head coach, his first priority was to get Lincoln Riley hired as his offensive coordinator away from Texas Tech. His second priority, he said, we need a quarterback that can run this Texas Tech-type spread offense. And they jumped on a plane, went down to Tampa, and they talked with Davis, who had committed, actually, to Skip Holtz at ECU after leaving junior college. And then he wasn't sure when Holtz went to USF down in Tampa, at South Florida. But then they talked him into it. They said this is going to be a wide-open offense. And actually, Davis saying that Ruffin McNeil actually won his parents over, his Papa Ruff. So the Pirates, 9 plays, 64 yards, and just 2:45, and they regain the lead. Ryan with the kick. It's going to be taken at the 18-yard line for Tulsa. And Milton Howell dropped over the 35 at about the 36-yard line. Penalty flag dropped at the 29, 17-yard return. Well, they're going to pick it up, celebrating its 6th year, sponsoring the Good Hands Field Goal Nets. Allstate makes contributions to participating universities' general scholarship funds for each field goal and extra point kick. To date, Allstate has contributed more than $2.1 million in scholarship monies. Yes, the penalty will be called against Tulsa. on the kickoff return, so that's going to bring that return back inside the 25-yard line. And back inside the 20-yard line, they will spot this one at about the 17.
Well, Ruffin McNeil has that defense now in a pretty good position. Tulsa's offense backed up at the 17-yard line, as you said, Mike. So you think that they want, the Pirates might want to bring some pressure here, put some pressure on the junior quarterback in Kenny, see if they can get a turnover deep in their own end.
Kenny, they keep it on the ground. Kenny, 11 of 16 for 102 yards passing so far. Last year, 23 of 46, 236, two touchdowns. But, you know, ECU scored 44 points. The coaching staff says that was a 23-17 game going into the fourth quarter. Kenny threw two pick sixes, and they had a fumble recovery.
We talked about those turnovers early in the game, and that's really been the Achilles heel of Tulsa the last two times out against ECU.
Four wideouts for Kenny down, and second down. Fires, has his man, it's complete over the 30-yard line, and that one goes to Charles Clay.
Just a strike on the outside, Mike. Just a nice job by Kenny throwing the football on time to Clay. And you talked about Clay earlier, Mike. Just a big target on the outside. A really good prospect for an NFL H-back or a fullback, but he can catch the football and run with it after catch.
Yeah, 4.4 speed at 235 pounds. Clay, five catches for 52 so far here this afternoon. Going to keep it on the ground, and there's some running room up over the 50 inside ECU territory. That's Jadarian Douglas, a 5'11 true freshman from Arlington, Texas. A gain of 20 on the play.
Good blocking out in the point of attack, and that's Charles Clay leading the way, doing a good job on the outside and letting the freshman Douglas get north and south, the end around from wide side to short side. And Tulsa starting at their own 17, starting to get a little bit of momentum offensively.
Jadarian Douglas led the state of Texas in rushing his senior year of high school. They keep it on the ground, and they get inside the 45-yard line. Johnson with the carry. Out of the Wildcat that time for Johnson. That's what, on the other side, Harris was hoping he'd run some Wildcat for Ruffin, but Lincoln Riley says we're not going to mess with that Wildcat situation. But Johnson gets the call on the Wildcat. He had 53 carries last year. So Kenny now facing a second and six, trying to regain the lead before halftime. Finds his man, boy, really threaded the needle down inside the 30-yard line. Trey Johnson, his first catch. Travis Simmons covering.
Mike, really impressed with the way Kenny's stepping up into the pocket, but never really taking his eyes off of the secondary. Watch him step up and hit Johnson to the outside. That's a bullet, you said, Mike. He threw that one on a rope to the outside. Good velocity on the football, good accuracy, and this offense of Tulsa's moving now.
Johnson picks up 15 on the play. Kenny looks, fires, going for the home run ball, and he overshoots his man, Charles Clay, the intended receiver.
Second down.
Now you look at Clay, we're talking about 235 pounds, 4.4 speed. Last year, down the stretch against Houston Southern Miss, he had 10 catches, 210 yards, four touchdowns, and four more rushing in the last two games.
That was a pretty good matchup on the outside, the 5'11 Blacknall against the 6'3 Charles Clay. If that ball was maybe a yard shorter, Clay might have had a chance to come down with that in the back of the end zone.
And they get it. They keep it on the ground as they try to establish. There's that true freshman, Thomas Roberson, on the carry. So once again, Graham trying to establish that running game to mix it with the passing game.
We've seen this end around, this almost sweep to the right side, the short side of the field, earlier by Johnson, now by Roberson. A good block down the field by the wide receivers and a shoestring tackle about the 10-yard line. But this Tulsa offense now trying to get it in for six.
They pick it up 10, 20 more yards. And Singleton gets the carry right up the middle. He's down near the 5-yard line. Inside 2 minutes, a minute 44 to go. Score here, and Tulsa would regain the lead before halftime.
Nice drive by Kenny, starting at their own 17, using a lot of clock and wearing down this Pirate defense.
Kenny, play action, fires, good coverage, ball is loose. Was it a complete ball or an incomplete pass? They're going to rule it incomplete. Bradley Jacobs coming up strong. Willie Carter, the intended receiver here.
Well, good play action, but everybody in a purple jersey staying at home. That's a great break on the football by Bradley Jacobs on Willie Carter, dislodging the football. They're going to call it a no catch, but that's a good job of staying at home in that secondary.
Jacobs, a transfer from Mississippi Gulf Coast Community College, says he hates the helmet-to-helmet rule. He is a throwback. He just loves to hit people.
Might want to get Kenny on the edge here, try to move him, but he's going to call a timeout and talk it over.
So third and goal. Todd Graham runs out on the field, calls the timeout. That's going to be their third, so they won't have any left here in the first 30 minutes with a minute 22 to go. Well, coming up on our halftime report, Ryan Burr and Robert Smith in the studio. Saturday surprises, and we'll have week two top matchups. Monster week, and a previewing of Boise State, Virginia Tech, the big game coming up Monday from the nation's capital. It's all coming up in the next minute 22 on our halftime report with Ryan Burr and Robert Smith.
Boy, we got a good one here, Mike. This is a nice job by both teams in their opener conference game. East Carolina really dominating the series the last couple of years, back-to-back conference champions. They've done a nice job of trying to hold serve at home with a four-point lead, but Tulsa now trying to ruin Coach McNeil's homecoming to be the head coach here. The first time he was able to leave the Pirates out. Exciting time for him, his dream job.
Yeah, Ruffin McNeil said he was, what a week he had when Leach left. Ruffin McNeil said that it was so rewarding after the victory, and then so disappointing when he didn't get the job. And speaking of Texas Tech, Robert Smith in the studio opened up his college career at Ohio State against Texas Tech. If it wasn't for Robert Smith, Ohio State would have lost that game. Third and goal. Kenny fires, and it's deflected. Simmons. Nice deflection from his cornerback spot to Damaris Johnson, the intended receiver.
Nice job. Just an in-and-out route, top of your screen, coming inside is Johnson, then back out, but nowhere to throw the football. Travis Simmons undercutting that pass, and no window on the outside for Kenny to fit it into. That's nice defensive coverage out on the edge.
Fitzpatrick on. This is the 12th play of the drive now. It'll cut it to one, and he does, after the 23-yard field goal by Kevin Fitzpatrick, the junior from Jensen Beach, Florida. So with a minute 13 to go before halftime, Tulsa moves down the field and cuts the lead to 17-16.
Well, a nice drive to finish off the half by offensive coordinator Chad Morris and head coach Todd Graham. They have to be happy on the sidelines that they go down, they get some points, they narrow the margin to one. But a good job by Kenny, really leading this offense, spreading the wealth out to Damaris Johnson, getting a little running by Watts. He did a nice job of mixing the run and pass, and now Tulsa feel a little bit better about themselves going into halftime with a little bit more momentum on offense.
And if you joined us late, this Tulsa team right there in the white uniforms back in 2007 averaged about 545 yards a game, number one in the country. 2008, about 570, or just under 570 yards, number one in the country. They averaged 47 points a game, and those numbers dropped last year in 2009, where they finished 5-7. As you check some of the numbers, yeah, they led the FBS in 07 and 08. They had 41 points a game and 47 points a game, dropping all the way to 29 points a game. But now, looks like they're finding that rhythm offensively here.
Well, they're trying to, and they're both looking really good offensively and defensively, both teams in their opener. A tough draw to get a conference game right in your opener, but not really good on the kicking game right here by the Golden Hurricane.
Yeah, it seems like both kickers are trying to keep it away from the star return men and Damaris Johnson and, of course, Dwayne Harris.
That's going to give this Pirate offense instant field position now with still a lot of time on the clock and one timeout remaining with 1:12 left to go for Coach McNeil's offense.
Yeah, these Pirate players call Coach McNeil Papa Ruff. Extension of their own family. There's Lincoln Riley now, 27 years of age. Birthday here this afternoon, calling his first game as an offensive coordinator at East Carolina after calling the shots for Texas Tech in that 41-31 win over Michigan State, where they piled up over 500 yards of offense. Dominique Davis, the former Boston College quarterback, out of the shotgun now. I think for the most part, after that 37-yard touchdown by Williams, Tulsa's done a pretty good job of corralling him.
They really have. They've done a nice job against the run, and it's been Davis out on the edge being able to be successful with the pass, and Walker coming up with the tackle there for the Golden Hurricane on first down.
I might stand corrected. Williams, 9 carries, 70 yards, so a pretty productive first half for number two. Gets the call again, and he tries to get up to the midfield stripe. Audric Ray making the stop on number two. Jonathan Williams, one career 100-yard game, and boy, they expected so much. East Carolina calls the timeout. That's their third of the first half, so both Tulsa and ECU using up all three timeouts. Rafa McNeil said he sat him down and said, hey, this is your last chance. Let's not blow it. We talked about the numbers. Williams, back-to-back 16-0 seasons at J.H. Rose High School right here in Greenville. Beat Independence High School out of Charlotte, that power for one of the state championships. And then he averaged 5.1 yards a game in his freshman year. Was on the conference all-conference USA freshman team. And then he just seemed to couldn't get out of the doghouse. He admits he had a hot head, and he was arrested three times back in 2008. But Ruffa McNeil saying during the meetings that he blames no one but himself for all those problems.
And it's one of those things where he's become a leader of this team now. When he's up and he's fiery and he's talking, it seems like the whole team is doing that. And sometimes when he has his dauber down a little bit and maybe not in the best of moods, the team doesn't really function as well. So I know Coach McNeil likes to see him up.
Yeah, that's a great point. Very interesting as Davis looks down and looking for a man, finds his man, and it's picked off. Or he had his man open at least. And this one's going to be picked off by Dexter McCoy. And Dominic Davis throws his first INT as a Pirate.
McCoyle, known for his hitting and coming up from the secondary to stop the run, this time playing center field, and not a very good throw by Davis. Davis sitting in the pocket under a little bit of pressure. He takes a big shot by Walker, but he had time to step into that football and maybe be a little bit more accurate with the football. He had his receiver on the outside. Let's hope he didn't hurt his wrist on that throw. But a good job by playing the secondary, McCoyle playing center field and getting the interception.
So Dominic Davis, who took over at BC, his redshirt freshman season, had 6 touchdowns, 4 INTs, gets his first year as a Pirate. G.J. Finney now with a chance with 29 seconds to go. They keep it on the ground. They get it to Trey Watts, freshman running back, and Melvin Patterson, and making the stop defensively. No gain on the play. So East Carolina, leading Conference USA last year. Scoring defense, first in total defense, plus 11. They lose 9 starters. And so far, they fared pretty well here in their first outing.
Thought they'd done a nice job offensively, other than that last turnover, but trying to go down deep and getting some more points before halftime. Quarterback's done a nice job, and Tulsa's done a nice job as well. But I would think Coach Ruffa McNeil doing a great job of getting his troops ready to come back out for the third quarter.
So the halftime score, East Carolina, the 2-time defending champs, on top by 1. Now let's go to the studio. Our halftime report, Ryan Burr and Robert Smith. And we're back in Greenville, North Carolina, on the campus of East Carolina. And you see the number 17-16, the 2-time defending champions on top of the Golden Hurricane of Tulsa by just 1 at halftime. Along with former Pitt quarterback John Kajemi, I'm Mike Gleason. And John, you go inside that locker room, I'd love to be a fly on the wall, because both these two teams, they kind of balance each other.
Yeah, I thought both quarterbacks played real well. They've tried to protect the football for the majority of the first half. The running attack, the up-tempo offense of both teams, I think they did an excellent job defensively of tackling in space and really trying to limit the big plays on both sides.
All right, let's take a look back now at our protection spotlight brought to you by Castrol GTX.
Well, there were some highlights offensively, but first defensively, the ECU defense causing a fumble on the outside. Damaris Johnson coughs it up and really sets up the first tough run of the afternoon by John Williams. He goes 37 yards, breaking multiple tackles to get into the end zone and put East Carolina on the scoreboard. In the end around, Tulsa using some trickery on their own, going to the outside, setting up a touchdown run of a yard by Singleton, going off the left side. The offensive line doing a nice job. Then the block kick by East Carolina and special teams. They do a nice job of getting away from it. But then again, there's that man, number 3 on the outside, Damaris Johnson. Watch the effort at the end of this, Mike. This is terrific. Getting into the end zone and really putting Tulsa, getting him some momentum on the outside. East Carolina wouldn't be denied. Dominic Davis finds a receiver outside. Then he goes over the top to Lance Lewis for 30 yards to make the score 17-13. Tulsa's going to add a field goal to make it 17-16 at halftime.
And you look at the numbers. Let our viewers digest these numbers for just a second, because look at, they mirror each other. Both quarterbacks throwing for 129, and it's hard to say who has the edge going into the second half.
Yeah, I think very evenly matched football teams, both offensively and defensively. The quarterbacks throwing for the exact same yardage. The running attack of Tulsa, they thought they needed to establish the run and play strong defense. Well, they're on their way to do that, Mike.
So what kind of adjustments are they looking for, looking at both coaches?
Well, I think more of the same for both teams offensively. They're doing a good job of mixing it up defensively. Whoever can cause turnovers in the second half should have it. East Carolina, a little bit momentum going to halftime.
Second half coming up after this.
A drug problem. 10% of the world's medicine is counterfeit,
affecting over a billion people a year. On a smarter planet, we're building intelligence into things.
So we can follow this medicine from the factory to the distribution center.
To the pharmacy.
And know it's the real thing.
Keeping counterfeits off the shelves.
In places like the U.S.,
Tanzania,
and India,
smarter medicine is safer medicine.
That's what I'm working on.
I'm an IBMer.
Let's build a smarter planet.
I never noticed that.
What?
The grill. Looks like an overhead shot of a stadium.
Thank you. The grill lines are the yard lines, which is what I've been saying. Football was created to make us grill.
Here we go.
Look, retractable dome.
That's not retracting.
You get it. Plus, what are most mascots?
Animals.
Think about it.
You do know there's people in those costumes, right?
Not all of them.
Take your dome, please.
Sorry.
Sporting Goods Kickoff Week.
Welcome back to ESPN's coverage of college football presented by 5-Hour Energy as part of Dick's Sporting Goods Kickoff Week. We've got a close one, 17-16. The two-time defending Conference USA champions from East Carolina sitting on top of Tulsa. Start of the third quarter, Tulsa's going to get the football, John, and it seems like they got into a little rhythm offensively.
They really did. I thought their quarterback, Kenny, did a nice job of establishing the mix of run and pass later in that second quarter, and the offensive line did a better job of protecting. So let's see what offensive coordinator Chad Morris and head coach Todd Graham, some of the adjustments that they may have made at halftime. I know one of the things they're going to keep constant is getting the football into Maris Johnson's hands. He's been electric on the outside, and I thought that Trey Watts did a nice job trying to run in between the tackles, so I look for number three. Big things for him in the second half.
And number three will get the ball at the two-yard line. Damaris Johnson over the 15 and dropped just shy of the 20-yard line, and that's where Tulsa will take over here to start the second half. A 17-yard return by the young man who led the nation in all-purpose yardage. Talking with Todd Graham last week, I said, give me an adjective on Damaris Johnson. He said, explosive. You said electric. So three carries, three catches. They definitely want to get him into the game plan more in the second half.
And they want to keep Kenny, keep getting him that high completion, 13 of 21, 129. Want to keep him rolling, but want to spread the football around, as well as Charles Clay. He played a big part of that first half as well.
Kenny, last year hitting 61% of his passes, eight different starting lineups on the offensive front. They keep it on the ground. Watts gets the carry. Run freshman and son of J.C. Watts, and no yardage on the play. Gets back to the line of scrimmage at best.
No gain on the play, 7 out of 10.
Tulsa 5-7 last year after going 10-4 and 11-3, but as we talked about in the first half, it was 23-17 against East Carolina. Opening the fourth quarter, they lost 44-17 thanks to turnovers. Five wideouts now for the Golden Hurricane. Kenny fires down the middle, and it's caught. That's number five, Ricky Johnson, the sophomore from Lafayette, Louisiana. Boy, he had it, dropped it, and got it again. Good concentration.
Boy, it was a nice job by Kenny of waiting for the linebacker, waiting for his receiver to clear the linebacker, and that's exactly what happened. Ricky Johnson's going to come down, and he's going to clear the linebacker, Melvin Patterson, right over the middle, and he does a great job of doing that effectively between the hashes. Good job of being accurate with the football.
Gain of 21 on the last play. Here comes the rush, and he gets rid of it. And he almost completed it up near the 40-yard line. Damaris Johnson, the intended receiver. There's number 38 in on the play. Davis, the first-team all-conference pick and preseason first-team all-conference pick again this year.
Mike, one of those corners with experience on the outside for the East Carolina Pirate defense, doing a nice job of going up and making a play on the football.
Kenny with a 2nd and 10. Looks and fires and finds his man. Nice job, Thomas Roberson again, the true freshman from Tulsa, Oklahoma. Picks up 12 more for Kenny. Both quarterbacks exactly the same numbers, 129 yards passing in that first half, and Kenny is really getting into a groove now.
Well, Mike, East Carolina is going to have to do something different to try to push the pocket, get a little pressure, because right now Kenny's got rhythm and he's throwing in rhythm.
In motion to keep it on the ground. Watts gets the call, and he's inside the 45-yard line, down to about the 44. Picks up four more on the play. Robert Jones making the stop.
Just enough running to keep you honest right now with Trey Watts and a little bit of Charles Clay, but right now it's all Kenny in the passing game. Plenty of protection and a nice job of just taking what's in front of him.
Kenny on second. Fires, and once again he finds his man, Charles Clay, who had a big first half. But Clay, the senior from Little Rock, Arkansas. Wes Pittman, the former walk-on, now starting linebacker, makes the stop, a gain of 5.
And you can see why everybody's raving over Charles Clay. That's a big man going from outside, inside to outside, and making a catch on the sideline, a tough catch. The ball was behind him, and he was able to slow his body, idle his body down, and make the catch, and a tough throw by Kenny. Third and short now for Tulsa.
Kenny and company facing a 3rd and 1. He keeps it, has the first down. G.J. Kenny. 22 touchdowns, 10 INTs last year, and a lot of those INTs came late in the season.
And a lot of them came against East Carolina. A lot of the turnovers over the last two seasons when these two teams met, that was the story for Tulsa. Today they're trying to play keep away from this Pirate defense, and in this opening drive of the second half, they're doing an excellent job.
Kenny with a streak of 95 consecutive passes last year without a pick. A little razzle-dazzle. And Damaris Johnson makes something out of absolutely nothing, because it was actually sniffed out pretty well by the Pirate defense. A gain of 4. And it looked like he was going to run into some heavy traffic in the backfield.
Well, that's a good job by Johnson, because this ball's designed to go back to the quarterback and let him throw the football. But he saw a Pirate in the offensive backfield. He blew his transmission around the 35-yard line, making that cut, and made a positive play out of a negative.
That Pirate you talked about, Josh Smith, the senior from Raleigh, busting in and busting up that play. But again, Johnson picks up 4 out of nothing. 2nd and 6 now. Little pump fake, and he comes back, and this one's going to be picked off. Travis Simmons In two games against Tulsa, Simmons with a 40-yard fumble return and a 72-yard INT for a touchdown, and he gets another one here.
Mike, we talked about the veteran play on the outside, and Travis Simmons does a nice job. They're trying to go on the throw behind to Damaris Johnson, but the one guy that kept his eyes on the quarterback was Travis Simmons. That's usually a guaranteed completion, except when you go against a senior that has seen it before. This guy's talented on the outside. He kept his eyes locked on the quarterback, Kenny, and made the big play.
Keep in mind, last year was 23-17. Kenny throwing two pick sixes and a fumble return for a touchdown by ECU. And ECU's defense losing nine starters. They had plus 11 in turnover. And right now, that's the second turnover here today.
Second turnover of the afternoon. And I know that makes Coach McNeil on that Pirate sideline very happy. But that's a good break on the football. And that's just a veteran play. Maybe getting a little bit greedy from the quarterback spot, but that's just a better defensive play. You're going to try to go and make a play to your best receiver on the outside. You're trying to make him feel like, hey, if the ball's not on target, let's try to break it up. But that was just a good defensive play. It looked like he had possession of the football and a foot in bounds.
It's under review right now. David Blackman upstairs, the replay official for Conference USA, trying to decide if indeed he had his foot in bounds. We're going to take another look at it. You have to have indisputable video evidence, and it looks like an INT to me, John.
Well, on the first brush, it looked like he had that left foot down when he had possession. Then he gets the right foot down, so actually 2 feet in bounds. And this is another good look at it. Watch the head of the cornerback, Simmons, turns exactly when the receiver, Johnson, turns for the football. There's possession with both feet in bounds. Looks like it's going to be Pirate football at the 21-yard line.
So that young Pirate defense, the only two starters were the cornerbacks. Travis Simmons, the senior from Tallahassee, and Emmanuel Davis, the junior, right here in North Carolina. And Ruffin McNeil now watching his Pirate defense get two turnovers so far here this afternoon. Brian Mitchell, the defensive coordinator who was at Texas Tech with Ruffin McNeil. What's the number one thing? He said that he loved the way the kids competed in camp, but what did he say? He had 40 guys that had never played in a football game. That was his biggest concern?
That was his biggest concern, a lack of experience, and he had it at the corners, Mike, but he didn't have it a lot of other places.
Early on the field is confirmed. It's an interception. First down, East Carolina.
Well, David Blackman gets down to Randy Smith. Smith delivers the message. It is an INT, and it's going to be East Carolina football with 11:42 to go in the third. Travis Simmons out of Tallahassee. Boy, athletic. When he was in high school, he was All-State on both sides of the football. So Dominique Davis and the Pirates with the football and the lead, 17-16. That's Williams. Davis keeps it, and it's sniffed out. Good job by Tulsa's defense. And Davis has nowhere to go. He's going to be dropped inside the 15-yard line.
Sometimes it's better the plays that you don't make as a quarterback, and Walker gets the sack for Tulsa, but that time, or the tackle for a loss on the play, but that time you get a little bit greedy at the quarterback position. Anytime you can get north and south and get down with maybe a minus two gain or even get back to the line of scrimmage is better than taking a big loss on first down. That goes for minus seven.
And again, Taren Walker. And defensive end in on the stop and good coverage. Pirate fans want some yellow laundry and they're not going to get it. Michael Bowman with two catches in the first half. The intended receiver, Arnick, the outside linebacker, making the defensive play.
Arnick with very tight coverage on that second down play, Mike, and trying to get the football to Bowman on the inside. And now the Pirates deep in their own end, third and long, difficult situation. The last thing you want to do here is turn the football over. Make a good decision at the quarterback position.
Pirates only 2 for 9 in third down conversions here this afternoon. Davis is going down. And it's a good thing he didn't cough up the football. John Flanders blitzing from the cornerback. And now they're inside the 5-yard line with a punting situation.
Well, great defensive stand. Great three plays by Tulsa. Flanders is going to come from the top side. It's a delayed safety blitz or corner blitz from the outside. The quarterback, Davis, never saw him. Even though he was retreating and drifting away from the pressure, 21 locked in on number 4, Davis, the whole way. And you were right, Mike. It was very fortunate Davis did not cough up the football.
Ben Ryan now deep in his own end zone. Nice spiral. Johnson at the 46. So Tulsa, down by one, will have great field position as Damaris Johnson gets inside the 35-yard line. 43-yard punt, 10-yard return, 17-16, but Tulsa has the ball.
What's your 2:30 feeling like?
Well, it's like my brain just stops working.
Feel fuzzy, groggy.
I can barely keep my eyes open.
So what do you do?
I used to get another coffee.
Yeah, coffee or soda.
Then another coffee.
But I switched to 5-Hour Energy.
Just one 5-Hour Energy.
The rest of the day, I'm great.
Zero sugar, only 4 calories.
I don't feel jittery. I'm in control.
It's me. Just a better, more awake me.
Gotta try 5-Hour Energy.
5-Hour Energy. Hours of energy now. No 2:30 feeling later.
You are largely nocturnal. You tend to run in a pack. And while quick to share with others, there is only one of you. The Droid Incredible by HTC. You are a social animal. You need the droid that is too. Exclusively at Verizon.
Sandwich lady, 2 o'clock.
Oh, hey.
5:50.
Actually, we're all good today, sandwich lady. We love your chicken sandwiches, but Taco Bell's got chicken flatbread sandwiches for under $1. So.
5:50.
No. 5:50. Under a buck.
You don't scare me.
It's under a buck, and not everyone's happy about it. The new chicken flatbread sandwich. Warm flatbread, flame grilled chicken, and melty cheese. Only at Taco Bell. Why pay more?
New Smirnoff Premium Malt Mixed Drinks. With the full flavor experience of a real mixed drink. And at 5.8% alcohol by volume, always be sure to get home safe. New Smirnoff Malt Mixed Drinks. Drink responsibly.
Man, you guys are always competing.
We're not competing.
Jenga, Texas style, baby.
Wow, I thought my second national championship ring was going to get in the way on that one.
I guess. Back in the day,
I used to be a Jenga master.
Oh.
Hungry hippos, baby. It's on.
ESPN College Game Day, built by the Home Depot. Saturdays at 9 a.m. on ESPNU, continues at 10 a.m. on ESPN.
College football in high definition is presented by Vizio.
Opening weekend of the 2010 college football season all comes to a head tomorrow night. Number 3, Boise State against 10th-ranked Hokies of Virginia Tech. The All-State kickoff in the Capitol as part of Dick's Sporting Goods kickoff week on ESPN. Tomorrow, 8 Eastern. College football available on TV, online, and on your phone. You go to ESPN.com for more information. That should be a good one. Best starting field position of the day for Tulsa now at the 34-yard line. After the 10-yard return by Johnson. And they keep it on the ground. Just over the line of scrimmage was Jeterian Douglas. He picks up maybe a yard. He had 1,800 last year. His senior year led the state of Texas.
Just a little inexperienced by the running back, Douglas. He ran right into Powell on the edge. His tackle was trying to kick out that big defensive end and ran right into the tackler.
Five receivers on the field now as Kinney works out of the shotgun. Empty backfield. Turns, fires near side. This one's complete. Inside the 30-yard line, Genesis Cole, the junior from Little Rock, Arkansas, with his first catch, picks up 5 on the play. Matt Thompson on the play defensively for the Pirates in Tulsa now. Huge third down play coming up here.
Well, if you're G.J. Kinney right now, you want to take advantage of the field position that was afforded to you by your defense. Come up with a big play. It's third and medium right here, 3rd and 5. Make a good decision from the pocket, and you may ask him to pick it up with his legs. They're spreading everybody out. Wouldn't be surprised if he ran this football, Mike.
Play in motion. And this one's complete inside the 10-yard line. The young freshman, Trey Watts, on the receiving end. And he's nailed by Derek Blacknall. But a nice pickup for Tulsa. 15 more yards, and they're knocking on the door again.
Boy, that's a nice catch. Good concentration by the freshman down the middle, Trey Watts. Quarterback's locked in the whole way because he's wide open. He knows the free safety can't break on the football quick enough in Blacknall. So that's a nice pitch and catch down the middle by Kinney to his freshman, Trey Watts.
Trey Watts moving from fifth string when they opened up camp to the starting tailback here. Johnson, nowhere to go. Good defensive play that time by Justin Lineback. He's been all over the play. Blacknall and Lineback both in on the play for ECU.
You have to give credit to the perimeter defense of the Pirates, especially in the plus territory. Everybody's staying at home. They know how fast Johnson is on the outside. And that's just a heck of a play by linebacker senior out of Climax, North Carolina, doing a nice job just staying at home and holding that edge.
Loss of three on the play, five wideouts for Kinney. Fires and has his man for the touchdown. Clay Sears, the tight end, whom we rarely see, picks up the 12-yard scoring toss. He only had four catches last year for Tulsa. The former quarterback went to wide receiver to tight end, has his first touchdown.
Well, the unknown man lining up at the line of scrimmage, the tight end, does a nice job. Does Sears just going off the ball and making himself big. 6'4", goes up and gets the football. And let's credit Kinney coming out. Other than that interception he's thrown, which wasn't a bad throw, it was just a better play. He's been dynamite in his third quarter.
Kevin Fitzpatrick right down the middle once again. And Tulsa is back in front now, 22-17. And again, Clay Sears seems like he fooled everybody, John.
Yeah, I think everybody was fooled. Chad Morris, the offensive coordinator, dialing one up. Just a nice job by Kinney, floating away, putting some air underneath the football for 6 points.
ESPN Sunday Night Baseball, presented by Taco Bell. Major League Baseball's Game of the Week. Sundays at 8 on ESPN. Everybody watches on Sunday night.
Are things different now that I'm not crushing quarterbacks every Sunday?
Yeah, a little bit. But I still have a taste for greatness.
So I love Dr. Pepper. The taste of these 23 flavors can never be equaled. Like me.
Pizza perfect nab.
I got it.
Donovan.
Mike? What, man?
Come on, Mike, man.
Still got it.
There's nothing like a pepper. Trust me. I've sent people to the doctor.
This is State Farm Pocket Agent Larissa Barano.
And I'm actual agent Larissa Barano.
Larissa can tell you how you can get discounts of up to 40%.
But so can your neighbors.
They can also tell you how State Farm's new Pocket Agent iPhone app can help you manage your account, find the nearest gas station, or
even help you call a tow truck.
And those are just a few of the perks experienced by the 40 million drivers insured by State Farm.
So talk to your neighbors, then call a State Farm agent like me.
It's a nice picture.
Thank you.
To your face. New Schick Hydro, water-activated gel that hydrates your skin as you shave and lasts up to twice as long as ordinary strips, while five blades with skin guards smooth the skin to reduce irritation. It's the best shave for your skin. The new Schick Hydro. Free your skin.
ESPN's College Football, brought to you by Dick's Sporting Goods. Every season starts at Dick's. And Dr. Pepper, there's nothing like a pepper.
Back on the campus of East Carolina University here in Greenville, 23-17. Tulsa, their best field position. Well, they take advantage of it, John. Five plays, 34 yards, and just 2-10 to take the lead.
Thought he did a great job, especially Kinney's hit 10 different receivers now in this football game. He's been spectacular in the third quarter, really dissecting where he wants to go with the football and making nice decisions from the pocket.
Fitzpatrick, Harris at the 15-yard line. Thought he had a lane, still on his feet. Over the 40, up to the 43. That lane shut down, but he still found some running room. Harris picks up 30 on the return.
A lot of missed tackles on special teams, and Dwayne Harris doing a nice job of keeping the play alive for this offense, trying to get this crowd back into it, too. There you see three would-be tacklers just go right by big number 17. He's got a good frame, and watch him finish this run right there. Just sticks his head down and goes through three white jerseys, gets a couple good blocks on the outside, and you love how skilled position players finish runs, and that's exactly what Dwayne Harris did there.
So Dominique Davis and the Pirates back on offense now. Davis fires, finds the big guy. 84, Justin Jones, 6'8", 252-pound redshirt freshman, picks up 9. You know, Todd Graham said they went from 10 and 11 wins down to 5. The team was humbled, but he felt the team responded. A very close football team. And more on that after this play for Dominique Davis, as Tulsa has regained the lead here, 23-17. Keep it on the ground for the first down. It's Giovanni Ruffin. Said at the top of the broadcast, sounded like there was 80,000 people in this 50,000-seat stadium, but getting kind of quiet here when both teams have the ball.
Well, Tulsa's done a nice job of making them sit on their hands a little bit in the second half. They've come out and taken the football down and taken the lead 23-17, but now Davis back out on the football field. That's good inside running by Ruffin.
Out of the gun, Davis has his man again. Lewis bounces off the would-be tackler. Lewis, 10, 5, his second touchdown if he didn't step out of bounds. For Lewis, and John, if he didn't step out of bounds, he did a great job because he was on the tightrope.
He really did, and he breaks a tackle of Dexter McCoyle, number 26, who's known as a collision hitter. Let's see if Lewis gets out of bounds. I don't see it yet. Boy, he did an excellent job of tiptoeing down the sidelines. He almost ran himself out about the 5-yard line, but did a great job of keeping his balance. And that's just a strong athletic play by a wide receiver for the Pirates.
And, John, we're talking with Ruffin at practice the other day. He said, hey, when he walked off the field, he said he could be a special player here, and pretty good numbers so far.
Yeah, 3 receptions for 79 yards and 2 touchdowns, and he's limping a little bit on the sidelines, but just a terrific play of breaking the tackle of McCoyle, who looks like he's down for Tulsa, but a nice job of staying in the pocket. There's the hit right there of McCoyle. He breaks it, and then he tightropes the sideline starting in about the 11-yard line. Looks like he was going to go out of bounds maybe 2 or 3 times on the play, but just a good job of a balance act inside the 10, and there's McCoyle going off. Tried to deliver the big hit on Lewis, but Lewis would not be denied.
Sophomore out of Louisiana. The 6 starts last year, still came up with 85 tackles, third best on the team. And he has a pick and 7 tackles so far here. A member of the Conference USA All-Freshman team. He had 13 tackles last year against these Pirates. He had 4 double-figure tackle games, so he'll be missed in that secondary.
After review, the ruling on the field stands. It's a touchdown.
Well, I guess they did review it. David Blackman upstairs said, yeah, he didn't go out of bounds.
And that'll get the crowd back into it. Mike, we were talking about him being a little bit quiet in this third quarter. Well, Lewis was able to provide that. If East Carolina can get an extra point here, they'll retake the lead.
And Michael Barber, he's perfect so far. And that's exactly what they do. They regain the lead by 1 as we take another look at this one.
Nice job by Lance Lewis breaking the tackle about the 20-yard line and tiptoeing in for the lead.
It doesn't take more than one person to talk to a woman. Stay thirsty, my friends.
Where can a marketing administrator be a watercraft engineer? Where can a doctor serve his community while also treating patients around the world? Where can a student stay in school while expanding his education beyond the classroom? In the U.S. Army Reserve, you'll find the strength to develop new skills and gain an edge to get ahead. There's strong, and then there's Army strong. Visit goarmy.com/reserve.
Make your next 16 Sundays way better. Only 4 days left. Sign up at ESPN.com/fantasy.
I'm not going to bed right now. I'm going to college. Thousands of people go to college in their pajamas every day. How is this possible? Because you can go to college online without leaving your home. Using your computer to get an online degree is really smart and easy. In fact, people with a degree on average earn $1 million more in their lifetime. So, how do you find a good online school? Well, get your computer and go online right now. Education Connection is a free service that connects hundreds of people each day to the best online colleges. And you don't want to pick the wrong online school. So, ladies, slip on your cute little fluffy slippers and, guys, cover up, please. And log on now, and Education Connection will send you their free success kit stuffed with information on online schools, scholarships, even degrees that take the least amount of time. This is a $100 value, and it's yours, free.
Log on to MySchoolNow.com. That's MySchoolNow.com. MySchoolNow.com.
Chance for Phoenix.
To ESPN, new home of the Bowl Championship Series.
And we're back in Greenville, 24-23. As expected, this game might not be as high scoring yet as some of these fans here thought it might be, but it's going to be a tight one down the stretch.
Very competitive. I think both offenses came out and made some nice adjustments at halftime. And especially Coach Ruff and McNeil. I think he's done a nice job in his first game as head coach here back at his alma mater, doing a good job of keeping the spirits high on the sidelines. And they're looking at Lance Lewis, who just tight-roped in from about the 10-yard line to take the lead, 24-23 for the Pirates. And Papa Ruff, hopefully he'll be able to come back for him.
Tavares Johnson at the 10-yard line. Johnson tries to weave his way through traffic up over the 30-yard line. A gain of 22. The NASCAR Sprint Cup Series heads back south for Labor Day weekend. Only two races remain for Jamie McMurray and Mark Martin to get off the bubble and back into the chase. The NASCAR Sprint Cup Series at Atlanta. ESPN tonight, 7:30 Eastern. So, the Golden Hurricane back with the football. We talked about their last drive, 5 plays, 34 yards, 2-10. Then you really have to take your hat off to ECU. They go 56 yards in 3 plays in just a minute 12.
Yeah, they can get it done quickly, and both teams doing an excellent job following the leadership of their quarterbacks.
Kenny out of the gun. Nice job of running that little option, and he's up near the midfield stripe, stopped at the 40-yard line. Not only can he throw the ball, he really reads the defense well.
He does a great job in the run game, and he's led this team last year in rushing. Did a great job again with the play-action fake. Give it to him, take it away, and look at him move on the outside. Good job. But right now, I'd like to see him get down on the ground, because he's a guy that you want to have playing in the next down. You don't want to take that big shot at the end of the play.
Defense, 15-yard penalty.
Yellow flag dropped at the Pirate 45, and it's going to be a face mask penalty against ECU, pushing the ball all the way down to the 36-yard line. So not only does Tulsa have some momentum, that doesn't help.
Might be right at the end of the play on Kenny. The face mask right there coming in, looked like 38, Emmanuel wow. Davis.
He held it for a minute there.
Yeah, he did, and that deserved at least 15.
Uncharacteristic for the all-conference player, Emmanuel Davis. Here comes the rush. Nice job of avoiding. He throws it out of bounds. Ricky Johnson was the intended receiver. Justin Dixon putting the pressure on that time for ECU. Number 5. He's had a good game so far for the redshirt freshman.
Dixon's going to come off the edge there. Really no one in a white jersey trying to get in front to hold him down. And the quarterback does an excellent job of eluding the pressure and throwing the football away. That's just being very aware, because you get a free blitzer on the right side in Justin Dixon. He doesn't miss much.
Third time he's pressured the quarterback this afternoon for the redshirt freshman. Second and 10 now for Tulsa. Kenny fires. Watts inside the 30. 25 spin. And the young freshman down to the 15-yard line. Finally, Josh Smith making the tackle, a gain of 21.
We have to have a lot of respect for Watts, the freshman running back. He was a fifth-team running back in the spring. Now, you tell me, Mike, if this guy looks like he's on anybody's 15. Look at the spin move on the inside, and then the toughness he shows inside the 20-yard line. That's just a great play by a young player.
And East Carolina now calls the timeout there first. They have two left here with
5:47 to go in the third quarter. You know, it's amazing watching Watts. Now, I understand that recruiting isn't a science, but he's first, number one, the lineage there. J.C. Watts, that's his kid. And Todd Graham, the head coach for Tulsa, saying that nobody really wanted him. He goes 200 pounds, and he rushed for 1,400 yards last year, and he winds up being a walk-on and starting his first game.
Well, he came to Tulsa gift-wrapped because this guy can play. He's tough. We've seen him run in between the tackles. We've seen him in space. We've seen him catch the football terrific down the seam, on the outside. He's done everything that's been asked of a running back, and he definitely has the running ability of his dad, because his dad could pick him up and put him down for the University of Oklahoma between 1976 and 81, and now he looks pretty good in a suit and tie as well.
Well, he could run that wishbone, huh?
He sure could. He did a great job up in Canada as well. I missed him up there. He had retired before I had gotten to Toronto, but he was a legendary runner and thrower up there as well. So a great career, J.C. Watts and his son really picking up the lineage.
And they keep it on the ground. Again, it's Watts inside the 15, down to the 13. Josh Smith in on the tackle again. So the lone senior on that defensive front picking up another tackle.
Well, now, Mike, in East Carolina, bow their back defensively. Good play by Smith up front, Josh Smith. But can they bow their back? Can they keep Tulsa and hold them to a field goal opportunity? They've got the big play guy on the outside in Johnson, number three. You would look for him to make some type of effort to get the football down inside close.
In the Wildcat formation now. There's the snap. Johnson out of the Wildcat inside the 10. He is quick. Down near the 5-yard line, stopped at the 7. Bradley Jacobs finally making the tackle for ECU. But here comes Tulsa.
Good call by offensive coordinator Chad Morris for the Golden Hurricane. Get the football in the guy that can make the scoreboard light up, and that's Damaris Johnson. Put him in that Wildcat formation, let him run the football in between the tackles, and now you get yourself in possibly a first and goal. And you really like the way Chad Morris has mixed up the run and pass. He said that to us earlier in the week, you need to be able to run the football in this league effectively, and they've done a nice job of using that balance on offense of the running of Trey Watts and Kenny, and the passing of Kenny.
And it's a first down. Now, John, earlier we talked about 07 and 08 when they had all these yards. Keep in mind that Gus Malzahn, who's now at Auburn, was the offensive coordinator. And then Todd Graham, who really focuses on defense. He was with Rich Rodriguez up at West Virginia, and he was the head coach for 1 year at Rice, so led Rice to their first bowl game in 45 years. He focuses on D. He was concentrating on offense, and now Chad Morris hired from the Texas high school ranks, and they're starting to move the chains. 46 offensive records set under Todd Graham, only his fourth year. Kenny back on the field. They get it to Watts, and Watts is hit again, number 5, and number 6, Wes Pittman. Well, there's a story there. Wes Pittman, too, senior from Raleigh, walked on. He played a wide receiver, linebacker. Now he's starting as a linebacker.
Yeah, he's done a nice job today. We've called his number plenty of times, number 6 in purple. He's done a nice job setting the edge for the Pirate defense. He's forced a fumble. He's had multiple tackles on the afternoon.
Second down, Kenny. Not too much running room. Picks up a yard, maybe. And again, Josh Smith. Big number 91, 6'1", 274-pound senior from Raleigh, and on the stop defensively.
Coming up on third goal now, Mike, probably the biggest play for this Pirate defense. You'd like to see the crowd get into it, but they're going to have to find a way to keep Tulsa out of the end zone. Kenny's still in the football game at quarterback, so you may not see any Pirate formation here. But you still got Damaris Johnson. You got number 9, Charles Clay, as well. Look for him, maybe a play-action pass in the corner.
Singleton back on the field. Kenny, touchdown. And it's a good call as Jameel Owens, the transfer from Oklahoma, gets his first touchdown as a Golden Hurricane. And what's really impressive now, 6 of 10 on third down conversions for Tulsa today.
Boy, good job by Jameel Owens getting in the traffic. He's here on the bottom. He's going to run out in the flat. And a nice job of just selling the pass protection initially. Good fake by Kenny. And then it's an easy pitch and catch to the back of the end zone. Looked like Chad Morris was on that page. You know, get everybody inside and let's play action and take the easy 6 points.
They tried for 2 earlier and did not get it. Here they go again. Up by 5.
Did they get it or did it touch the ground? Well, Kenny rushed it just a little bit. If he would have taken a half a second longer, I think they would have pulled it in. So twice now they failed on the two-point conversion. Looking for Beaver, the backup quarterback at that time for the two-point conversion.
He was wide open, and Kenny can't believe this is probably the easiest throw. It looked like a hand grenade going into the end zone, trying to get it to his backup quarterback, Beaver, who didn't have a chance to catch the football. And that's what head coach Todd Graham's going, that had to be the easiest throw we asked you to make. Don't worry about it. Let's just come back. And you got to laugh sometimes about it. And that's one of the things that Chad Morris really wanted to bring to his quarterback, Kenny, is to have fun out there. And you don't have fun when you don't complete a two-point conversion when it's wide open, but let's blow it off because you've done a great job up to this point, and now we've got a five-point lead.
And we're saying last year a season of missed opportunities, but Todd Graham said, no, we just didn't get it done. We were humbled last year, but the kids have responded. And this year, if you look at their helmets right on top of the face mask, it's written heart, and this team is all about heart. He says, everybody, it's about relationships. To a man, everybody had to stand up there and tell the entire team who their hero in their life was. In each game, they're supposed to play for their hero.
Well, it's a credit what Todd Graham has done at Tulsa. You know, he feels better about this team than any team he's ever coached. And he said to me during the week, he said, we're not a team of finger pointers. We're thumb pointers because it all starts with me.
He said it's been the closest team he's coached. Again, only his fourth year here, but the team is very, very tight. And now they're back in the lead. Kick goes down near the 10-yard line, and it's taken by Jonathan Williams, the return man that time for ECU. So Williams, we talked about the fact in high school he averaged 11, 12 yards a carry. He averaged about 7.2 in the first half here today.
Well, he did a great job in the first half. He had that 37-yarder for a touchdown. And he's going to need more big plays in the second half going into the fourth quarter with 3:19 left to go in the third quarter.
Well, the last time Tulsa, 5 for 34. They scored a touchdown. ECU responded. Now Tulsa goes 68 yards in just 8 plays. We'll see if Dominique Davis and company can respond.
Yeah, that face mask penalty really hurt the Pirates defensively.
Two backs in the backfield now for Dominique Davis. Ruffin and Williams, while Davis works out of the shotgun. Three wides, Davis fires, and it should have been caught a little bit high, but Dwayne Harris, who rarely drops a ball, lets this one fall incomplete.
Well, it's a good thing that he may have bobbled that football because Skilkins on the outside, the corner, came off of the wideout and really disregarded the go route, was ready to put a shot on the inside. You can see the receiver at the top of the screen. It may come back to that, pump that out route, and go for the go route.
Williams breaks to the outside, looks for that lane, still on his feet, and he's going to be close to the first down. Looks like he has it. Well, I can see why this coaching staff really is impressed with this young man.
Just a strong running back, Mike. It's hard for one person to bring him down. Charles Davis misses on the outside, and look at those legs, the strength of the running attack by Jonathan Williams. He lost some weight in the spring, and he went to the black shirts. That's the strength and conditioning guys here at East Carolina, and they do a good job of trying to motivate people to do what they want them to do. We saw them at practice a couple days ago, and they have a lot of fun, but they respect the players, and the players in turn respect them.
Davis comes out firing, and this one's almost picked off. Oh, Brian Moore. They weren't sure if Brian Moore was going to play today, and he almost had a pick six. Intended receiver Michael Bowman.
Great break on the football. Just undercuts the route. And Brian Moore, as you said, gets that right hand on the football. And it's another indication, Mike, that the cornerbacks are coming off the go routes and really hanging inside with the quarterback with their eyes. I would hope that Dominique Davis looks outside.
Davis goes to one of his inside receivers there. And that's Michael Bowman. Bowman with his third catch of the day picks up 4 on the play. Arnick, one of the linebackers, covering defensively. So we approach the two-minute mark here in the third quarter. Pirates just 2 of 10 on third downs. Last year when they won the championship, they converted 44% of the time. And they swing it out to Giovanni Ruffin. And Ruffin picks up the first down up near the 45-yard line. So Ruffin picks up 10, moves to chains,
inside 2 minutes.
Well, you love the call by offensive coordinator Lincoln Riley. Nobody to the short side of the field. And Giovanni Ruffin, he makes you pay at the end of his runs. He's doing a good job of finishing runs, and so is Jonathan Williams for that matter. The Pirates get that first down and looking for more big plays.
Ruffin stays on the field, cuts it back up near the midfield stripe, stopped at the 49-yard line. Arnick on the tackle after a gain of 4. And we have about 90 seconds to go in quarter number 3. And it's been a good one. A lot of blowouts in opening weekend, as expected, but not the case here. 29-24, and it's been a tennis match here in the second half. Lewis complete inside the 45-yard line. Lance Lewis with another catch. 9 more for number 88, Lewis. And, boy, he's having a memorable opener here.
He really is. He looks a little bit banged up on the sidelines, but that's the pass that Dominic Davis wants to take on the outside. It's there all afternoon, that quick pass on the outside. And Lewis, 4 for 88 and 2 touchdowns on the afternoon.
Again, at practice the other day, the coaching staff, as he walked by, said, boy, that young man right there could be special out of East Mississippi Community College. And look at this. Well, these running backs, they're not going to go down again. Giovanni Ruffin gets the call. And again, Antle makes the tackle, but 12 more for Giovanni Ruffin. I think he saw the talented Williams average about 7 yards a carry in the first half, and he wants some totes as
yeah,
well.
I think so. I think he wants a piece of this running attack. He did a nice job inside the tackles, making the first man miss and the first contact bounce off of him. Just as Jonathan Williams did that in the first half, Giovanni Ruffin's doing that in the second half.
Tulsa calls the timeout. They've got 2 remaining here with 1 quarter and 37 seconds to go. So 15 minutes and 37 seconds to go before they drop the curtain on opening weekend here in 2010. Don't forget, coming up next weekend, we have Monster Saturday, some huge games coming up. Well, what a schedule, huh? Sooners take on Florida State. And the Buckeyes taking on Miami in the Horseshoe. Alabama, number 1. Penn State going down to see the Crimson Tide. That's interesting. That's a great matchup right there in Oregon and Tennessee. But Penn State, how about a freshman quarterback? The first ever for Joe Pa, 20 of 29 yesterday.
Yeah, it's been a long time. It never happened. And had an excellent day. And the game I really want to watch, I want to see Ja'Cory Harris for the University of Miami go up into the Horseshoe and battle a defense from Ohio State. Everybody's talking about Ohio State, that they're going to have one of their best teams this year that they've had in 7 or 8 years. And I want to see how Terrell Pryor responds to the pressure and the speed of Miami's defense.
And the pressure of the media, because it's going to be Pryor against Ja'Cory Harris, even though it's Miami against Ohio State.
Exactly.
You're going to hear that all week long. 50,010 here to open up the season. A little razzle-dazzle now in the bag of tricks. And but Tulsa's not falling for it. Harris gets the call. Harris last year, 83 receptions, 31 carries, picks up 6 that time.
Mike, the one thing you like about both coordinators offensively is they try to get the football in the hands of their playmakers. This time, Dwayne Harris trying to get a big play on the end around. That's just a good job by Riley, the offensive coordinator.
2nd and 4. Davis. He ran that fake good, just like Kinnegan.
Both quarterbacks very mobile, and they can get to the outside. And when you run this spread offense, the first fake really draws in that defensive front 7. If you have enough speed and enough patience to get to the outside, you can get out there and really gain some valuable yards in big chunks.
They spread guys around. I heard a middle linebacker say recently it gets pretty lonely down in the box when you're playing middle linebacker against these spread offenses. But we've played 3 quarters of football here in the opener from Greenville, North Carolina. And right now it's 29-24. ECU, the 2-time defending champions, playing from behind. Final 15 minutes here in Greenville, coming up right after this.
The NASCAR Sprint Cup Series at Atlanta, tonight at 7:30 Eastern on ESPN.
Like summer, it's here, but not forever. The Lexus Golden Opportunity Sales Event. Lease the 2010 IS250 for $349 a month for 36 months, with $3489 due at signing. See your Lexus dealer.
Folks, welcome to the neighborhood, where Applebee's 2 for 20 is better than ever this season. More from the sideline.
That's right, Boomer. Applebee's 2 for 20 is stuffed with more flavor, like rich and tender Florentine ravioli with chicken and provolone stuffed meatballs, plus classics like the fire-grilled 7-ounce sirloin. One appetizer, two entrees, $20. Back to you, Boomer.
The best deal in the neighborhood just got better, and the Swami predicts total domination.
And there you have it.
There's no place like the neighborhood. Open until midnight or later.
For 10 years, StubHub has been the place to find great tickets to sports, concerts, and more, even on the day of the event, and even if it's sold out. But if you didn't use StubHub, we suggest you pack accordingly. StubHub, where do you want to sit?
Summer, it's here, but not forever. The Lexus Golden Opportunity Sales Event. Lease the 2010 IS250 for $349 a month for 36 months, with $3489 due at signing. See your Lexus dealer.
I may be in my pajamas right now, but I'm not going to bed. I'm going to college online. Education Connection will connect you to the right online college for free.
Log on to MySchoolNow.com. That's MySchoolNow.com.
Greenville, the start of the fourth quarter. I mentioned 50,010, second largest crowd in school history. Pirates looking for their third straight Conference USA Championship, trailing the ball game 29-24. Davis, 204 yards passing, 22 yards rushing. And they keep it on the ground. No running room that time. They'll be lucky to get back the line of scrimmage. You know, Dominique Davis last year led the junior college ranks with 492 yards a game. At least his team did. It looked like anything. He's just fine-tuned his game since leaving Boston College a couple of years ago.
Well, I think that's the main reason why he got the start today. His experience, his leadership. He's been there before. He's been in big situations. And he's really done a great job of managing the offense today and taking what's there and using his legs to help him out.
Davis going over the middle. Finds his man. Again, it's Lewis. Lance Lewis goes 6'3", 200, good size. He keeps playing like this and listening to his coaching staff and continues to work hard. He could be playing on Sunday afternoon.
Yeah, Marco Nelson on the coverage, but another nice catch in traffic by Lewis.
30th pass attempt for Davis here this afternoon. Big third down play as they trail. Cody Wilson was showing blitz there for a second.
Big play receiver right here, Mike, to the slot on the right side.
Davis swings it out, finds his man, and it's complete, and it's Williams, the running back. And a big third down play. It was third and three, and now it's going to be first and goal after picking up the first down.
Well, that's a nice job by the eyes of the quarterback in Davis. He wanted to go inside, but he let his tailback get outside of the defense, and that allowed him to get inside of the 5-yard line, and now a quarterback run or a Jonathan Williams burst will give East Carolina the lead.
Four wide receivers. Davis. It's a foot race now. Davis will take it in for the touchdown.
Well, Arrington and Womack on the outside, they do a terrific job of blocking and getting a stalemate as a receiver on a defensive back, and that allows Dominique Davis to go outside. After the play fake to Jonathan Williams, he's able to get to the outside, but it was Arrington and Bowman on the outside.
Michael Barber with the kick. And his first game kicking as a Pirate, he's perfect today. And Dominique Davis leading the Pirates on an 80-yard, 14-play drive. Davis has thrown for two touchdowns and now run for one.
Sunday night NFL games and NFL Red Zone. Now everything football is everywhere. Only with Verizon. Rule the air. Like summer, it's here, but not forever. The Lexus Golden Opportunity Sales Event. Lease the 2010 IS250 for $349 a month for 36 months with $3489 due at signing. See your Lexus dealer.
To your face. New Schick Hydro. With water-activated gel that hydrates your skin as you shave and lasts up to twice as long as ordinary strips, while five blades with skin guards smooth the skin to reduce irritation. It's the best shave for your skin. The new Schick Hydro. For your skin.
Everyone.
So much, we're making even bigger changes at Pizza Hut. We're lowering the price of every pizza on the menu. A large pizza with up to three toppings is just $10. Medium specialties like Pan Supreme or Pepperoni Lover's Pizza are just $10 too.
No coupons, no limited time offers.
Just every pizza at a great price, every day.
We've changed just about everything. Well, except how your favorite pizza tastes. Now lower prices, only at your Pizza Hut.
Like summer, it's here, but not forever. The Lexus Golden Opportunity Sales Event. Lease the 2010 IS250 for $349 a month for 36 months with $3489 due at signing. See your Lexus dealer.
You're watching ESPN, new home of the Bowl Championship Series.
31-29, ECU back in front. Dominique Davis says in high school he ran a pass-heavy system at Boston College, a pro-style offense at Fort Scott Community College, an I-formation. Now he's running the spread, and so he's seen it all.
Yeah, for his debut, he's doing a pretty good job of making nice reads, but doing a good job of using his athleticism on the outside. He has 9 carries for 24 yards, but throwing the football 18 of 31 for 217, 2 touchdowns, and only 1 interception. I thought he did a nice job of decision-making in that drive and then using his athleticism to get him inside for 6 points.
Ryan with the kick. You saw number 3, Damaris Johnson, the deep man for the return. He'll take it at the 9-yard line. And he's tripped up inside the 25-yard line. That was a nice play there by number 34, Torrance Hunt. Return of 15 yards, and Hunt said that's as far as you're going to go.
Yeah, and this is a guy, open field tackling and special teams, not an easy task, but Hunt does a great job of providing that leadership on special teams.
And for those of you tuning in at 5 o'clock, you're looking for the NHRA Full Throttle Drag Racing Series, a qualifying coverage of the Mack Tools U.S. Nationals continuing. From Indianapolis, we'll be heading to Indy
right after this ball game. There's 13-18 to go, and it's been a good one. G.J. Kinney fires, looking for Ricky Johnson, and Johnson is laid out.
Passing down for number five, Ricky Johnson falls incomplete.
Ricky Johnson, a sophomore, hit hard, but actually the defensive back.
Yeah, it looked like Blacknell, number 26, coming in to deliver the hit and the tackle on Johnson. Slow to get up. Anytime you throw that football up in the air where your receiver has to climb the ladder to catch it, you expose those ribs, and that's exactly what happened to Blacknell on Johnson. But it looks like both guys kind of staggering around, and it looks like Blacknell will be able to be assisted to the sidelines.
He's a junior from Greensboro, replacing Van Eskridge. Well, you talk about this defense losing nine starters. Van Eskridge had 102 tackles. Nick Johnson, 99. Chris Maddox, 86. Jeremy Shambliss, 85. Those are just the top four guys. That's 372 tackles gone from last year's championship team. New rule this year, if you're banged up, you can't stay on the field. You have to leave the field for at least a play. Kinney now with five wideouts. Turns, fires to the near side, looking for Watts, the running back. It falls incomplete. Six lead changes, largest lead, seven for the Pirates of ECU.
I don't know, Glee, about you. I might need some oxygen here for this fourth quarter. These teams have been going up and down the field. We saw the lead change summary there. Now on third down, where Kinney needs to be at his best for his head coach, Todd Graham, and offensive coordinator Chad Morris, has to make this play on third down. It's a big one in the fourth quarter.
Six defensive backs in for ECU. Kinney steps up nicely, looking and finding his man open at the midfield stripe, and he's still on his feet. Willie Carter is going to take it to the house. Two or three missed tackles there, and Willie Carter goes all the way for the touchdown. He's a sophomore from Crockett, Texas, 75 yards covered.
Mike, this is one name we really haven't mentioned today, and that's Willie Carter, but he gets behind the secondary and gets behind the coverage of Wes Pittman, the strong side linebacker, 75 yards. Just a great job on third down.
And again, going for two for the third time, and for the third time, unsuccessful. So Willie Carter, the fact that we haven't mentioned his name much, he plays behind Charles Clay, but last year Carter, as a true freshman, played in 12 games, averaged 5.9 yards a carry. This time he goes 75 on the receiving end. And once again, Tulsa moves back out in front in the fourth, 35-31.
Your 2:30 feeling like?
Well, it's like my brain just stops working.
Feel fuzzy, groggy.
I can barely keep my eyes open.
So what do you do?
I used to get another coffee.
Yeah, coffee or soda.
Then another coffee.
But I switched to 5-Hour Energy.
Just one 5-Hour Energy.
The rest of the day, I'm great.
Zero sugar, only 4 calories.
I don't feel jittery. I'm in control. It's me. Just a better, more awake me.
Gotta try 5-Hour Energy.
5-Hour Energy. Hours of energy now. No 2:30 feeling later.
Precision handling, high performance braking, smooth and comfortable ride. Tame the road, Hankook tires.
Get up to $60 cash back rebate when you buy 4 select Hankook tires. See your local retailer for details.
Six, that's the number. 6 out of 10 Americans are now in debt. That's over half the country. So if you're in trouble with debt, you're not alone. If your credit card bills are piling up and your balance just isn't going down, call Consolidated Credit now. They'll get the credit card companies to reduce or eliminate your interest. They'll consolidate your bills into one easy payment, and they'll cut your monthly payment by up to 50%. All that so that you can pay off your debt fast. 6 out of 10 people may be in debt, but one call to Consolidated Credit can get you out. They're the freedom people.
Call now, 1-800-225-8856, 1-800-225-8856, 1-800-225-8856.
Consolidated Credit. When credit card debt is the problem, they're the solution.
ESPN's College Football is presented by 5-Hour Energy. Hours of energy now, no 2:30 feeling later. For more information, visit 5hourenergy.com. And in part by the Lexus Golden Opportunity Sales Event, now through September 7th at your Lexus dealer.
Uncle Gammy's Rib Shack. Uncle Gammy's Rib Shack, and I think Todd Blackledge probably wishes he was here this weekend.
Those ribs were good. I think they're going to have to roll me out of here tomorrow, Mike. We have to go back there tonight.
Well, how about the groove that G.J. Kinney is finding down here in the second half? Three touchdowns for him, and once again, Tulsa has regained the lead 35-31. You know, 19 different guys have caught a ball here. And to make this game crazy, there have been 19 missed tackles in the game.
It's been an offensive aerial, you know, performance by both quarterbacks, and the receivers has just been spectacular on the edge.
Jonathan Williams upended over the 30-yard line, gets up to the 32. Kevin Fitzpatrick, the kicker, makes the tackle. Let's take a look at Kinney's numbers.
Kinney's done an excellent job of moving the pocket and finding the open receivers down the field. I thought his patience in the pocket, his legs, being able to run the football, making him miss in the middle of the football field. He's done a nice job with his head, with his decision making. He had one interception and really wasn't that bad of a pass, but inside, in the plus territory, he found a receiver in the back of the end zone. Then he finds Willie Carter for the 75-yarder. So Kinney has done an excellent job. In the first half, he was 13 of 21. For 129. In the second half alone, 19 of 15 for 171, three touchdowns and an interception on the day.
15 of 19.
I'm sorry. Yeah.
I was going to say, boy, he really is playing well, huh? Here's Bodenheimer with the catch. He's up over the 35-yard line. Andrew Bodenheimer, a sophomore from Clemens, North Carolina. He's gone from a walk-on. Played special teams, six receptions in the spring game for 83 yards and a couple of touchdowns. So, boy, they've got a ton of receivers on this team.
They really do. And what you like what Chad Morris has done with his offense is put a lot of pressure, taking it off of the quarterback, and really put the pressure on the receivers to be in the right spot.
So we'll see if Dominique Davis and the Pirates can answer again. It seems like they've been answering all the second half, but sooner or later, I think the team, unless they throw a pick, the team with the football last might win this football game. Going up top, looking deep, and it falls incomplete. Looking for Lance Lewis once again, who has a couple of touchdown receptions already here today.
Dominique Davis has done a nice job in his debut for East Carolina. Now you come up with a third down, still plenty of time in the fourth quarter, down 4 points. Try to get this football to a playmaker, make it easy pitch and catch to one of his inside receivers.
Showing blitz on the top of the screen. Davis fires. Harris over the 50. Harris, 30. Caught from behind by Tanner Antle. Otherwise, he might have been gone.
Davis trying to hurry up that offense, but a nice, easy throw. Everything's right in front of him. He has the underneath route to his playmaker, Dwayne Harris, who almost turns this into 6 points. This is about a 5-yard pass play that could have went down the field. It does go for 39 yards.
Harris came in number one career-wise with 67 catches. That's tops the charts, 104 yards shy of the record for receiving yards here at ECU. Ruffin gets the call.
Nice inside running, Mike, by Giovanni Ruffin. But right here on the outside, that's your playmaker, and he's going to go down and inside, just an easy underneath route, and it's easy for the quarterback. Just a stick move on the defensive back, and he almost turns a 5-yard pass into a touchdown. It goes for 39, but that's a simplistic way of making an easy play from your offensive coordinator, Lincoln Riley. The play's right in front of you, pitch and catch. Big play.
There's number 94, 6'3", 265-pound junior college transfer, Tyrone Walker out of Louisiana. He's had a big, big game for Tulsa. Seven tackles, one tackle for loss in his first game
as a Golden Hurricane. Mentioned Dwayne Harris, 104 yards shy coming in for the receiving record. He's got 69 on three catches here so far today. And as we see, Walker, number 94 on the left of your screen there. Looks like that right knee might have been caught in some heavy traffic, and he's going to limp off, and definitely limping on that right knee.
And that's a guy that relies on his quickness from the edge, from that defensive end position. So you hope that he's, looks like a hamstring or a right leg problem for sure.
Conference USA up for grabs this year, huh? You got Central Florida expected to have the best defense in the East. You have Houston over in the West with Case Keenum and company. And now you have Dominique Davis and the Pirates are trying to get that third straight title. That was a big second down run. Picks up the first down, or he should be close.
The guy that's been doing damage down here has been Lance Lewis. This is a good job by the quarterback, knowing where the first down markers were. He stretches out the football, gets the first down, and now at the top of your screen, 88, that's Lewis. That's the guy that's been doing all the damage for the Pirates inside the 20-yard line. Big plays.
Plenty of time. Davis, here comes the rush now. And he throws it out of bounds wisely. Cody Wilson finally came out and put some pressure, but Davis had all day until number 41 showed up.
Yeah, good job by the secondary for Tulsa. Wilson showed up on the scene with pressure, but a good job inside the 10-yard line by this defensive secondary. Everybody had great coverage, and everything happens a little bit quicker as a quarterback right now. So if you don't see it quickly, you got either have to tuck it and run or throw the football away.
Second down, they can pick up the first down down at the 2-yard line. Whistles will stop this one before it gets rolling. Audric Ray jumped offside for Tulsa. Audric Ray, the senior.
Offside. 90 on the defense. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Pancholinas, the starting defensive end, opened up at the nose, showing some versatility, playing right over Dalton Faulds, the sophomore center for ECU, and just to push Faulds back.
Mike, that allows ECU to use both one of their two running backs, Jonathan Williams or Giovanni Ruffin, for some inside running game.
And it's going to be Ruffin, and he has nowhere to go as Brian Moore comes up from that bandit spot, makes the tackle. Ruffin, a senior out of Virginia Beach, Virginia. Had a couple of touchdown rushes in the Conference USA title game against Houston last year. It sounds like number two, Jonathan Williams, from right here in Greenville, he will be the man in that backfield, along with Dominique Davis so far this year. Inside 10 minutes to go now in the ball game. Davis, plenty of time, fires, and there's Harris for the touchdown. The senior from Stone Mountain, Georgia. Seven of those touchdowns through the air last year, five on the ground, and that is a big one for ECU because the Pirates regain the lead.
Offensive coordinator Lincoln Riley says this guy's versatile. He sure is. He had a lot of time. Credit that offensive line for protecting Davis. Gave him enough time to look around, scan the secondary, and find his playmaker, Harris.
Michael Barber, who lost the kicking job to his best friend at Maryland, is perfect so far today. Lincoln Riley, the 27-year-old offensive coordinator, watching his team go 67 in just eight plays.
Plenty of protection. He finds the playmaker in the back of the end zone. This guy gets in and out of routes well. Well, he just pushed the lead to 38-35.
Like summer, it's here, but not forever. The Lexus Golden Opportunity Sales Event. Lease the 2010 IS250 for $349 a month for 36 months with $3489 due at signing. See your Lexus dealer.
Look, we've all dealt with the itching of athlete's foot. I can't just wash it away. Killing it takes clinical strength. I only use Motrin Ultra. Its powerful formula can even cure severe cases of athlete's foot. Nothing cures better. Motrin Ultra, the killer cure.
With mouth-watering real fruit and
refreshingly blended with creamy, low-fat yogurt. McDonald's new strawberry banana and wild berry smoothies are 100% pure sipping fun. The simple joy of real fruit smoothies.
New Smirnoff Premium Malt Mixed Drinks. A delicious collision of blueberry and lemon. And a real mixed drink taste worthy of a glass. 5.8% alcohol by volume. Please drink responsibly.
You ain't hip hop.
TV star.
Come on, son. You never be like your dad.
Fastest mobile broadband network. AT&T. Rethink possible. Buy a Pantech messaging phone like an Impact and get a Pantech messaging phone free after mail-in rebate.
Like summer, it's here, but not forever. The Lexus Golden Opportunity Sales Event. Lease the 2010 IS250 for $349 a month for 36 months with $3489 due at signing. See your Lexus dealer.
The U.S. Nationals is the biggest event of the year in drag racing, and they've been breaking track records left and right. They've done it in every class, and there's still one more session left to go. The final session after the game.
We'll see if there's a couple of touchdowns left to go here in Greenville, North Carolina. 38-35. Pirates back on top by three. Damaris Johnson, the deep man, back at the 10-yard line. A 50,010 at the game today. Second largest crowd in the history of East Carolina football. And there's Mr. Johnson. 5'8", 170 pounds, and quick as lightning. Played in 27 games now, and he's caught a ball at least once in 27 games. Look at Johnson. Finds a lane. Johnson. Midfield stripe inside the 45 and finally dragged down at the 41-yard line. Damaris Johnson. Leonard Paul finally takes him down with his fourth tackle.
We talked about Johnson in the open. He can make things happen. He's the all-purpose yardage leader last year, and on special teams, he can do it all. He's electric, Mike. He's got that extra gear, and when he gets into the open field, most times you don't catch him. This time, the Pirates did a nice job of trying to track him down, but if he stays outside, he may have continued to go down that sideline.
Here's Kenny going back to work now. They keep it on the ground. Watts gets the call. Again, number five. Making the initial contact. That's Dixon along with Maurice Mercer, number 94. So Trey Watts, 5'11", 201-pound redshirt freshman, moving his way from fifth string to the starting tailback. You see Johnson now with all-purpose yards. 190 returning yards, 64 rushing, 36 receiving. This one's complete, and it's down to the 10-yard line. It's the freshman, Roberson. Boy, somehow he's stuck behind the secondary.
Well, that's because Kenny kept the play alive, Mike, in the offensive backfield. I thought the Pirates did an excellent job in coverage early, but watch Kenny. He's going to keep the play alive, keep his eyes down the field, and he's able to find the freshman, Roberson, just wide open down the right side, and that's just veteran leadership by your quarterback, keeping the play alive and making positive plays.
Watts, nowhere to go that time. He's tripped up by Thompson, number 28. That's Matt Thompson. Well, I guess I spoke too quickly, John. We just went over 500 yards here for Tulsa. And that's where they wanted to get back. But they wanted to establish the running game, and they pretty much did that with Watts today. And Kenny having a big game now and working with five wideouts who, with 8:30 to go, trying to regain the lead. Over the middle, almost picked off. Blacknall. They were looking for Charles Clay.
Well, that time, Brian Mitchell, the defensive coordinator, dials up some pressure. The Pirates go man coverage. They were trying to get underneath Tulsa was Clay, but a better matchup by Blacknall. He did an excellent job of getting inside, and actually the pressure in the pocket made Kenny want to throw the football a little bit earlier than he anticipated or would have liked to have. He would like to have held it a little longer.
Third and goal. Kenny looks right, comes back to the left side, and it's up in the air, and it's caught. It's another touchdown for Tulsa. Trey Johnson came over and grabbed the deflected ball, and so Trey Johnson now, with his first touchdown in 2010, he is seven shy of tying the school record.
Unbelievable play. They were trying to get the football to Roberson, the freshman. Kenny sticks it in there. It's a nice break on the football by Davis, but the ball's deflected, as you said, Mike, goes right to Trey Johnson, and he dives for the football in the back of the end zone. Another huge play on offense for Tulsa.
And once again, Kevin Fitzpatrick on to kick the extra point. He might sprain his ankle here today kicking so many extra points. So four touchdown passes now by G.J. Kenny. This one goes to Trey Johnson.
Well, nice protection by this offensive line. Kenny looks right. He scans the field, comes back, tries to get it to his freshman, but it was a nice break on the football by Emmanuel Davis, one of the experienced defensive backs for the Pirates. This ball's going to bounce straight up in the air, Mike. It's a great right hand by Davis, but unfortunately it goes right to the arms of Trey Johnson, who picks up the touchdown reception.
And that came on a third and goal with the ball resting at the 11-yard line. So Trey Johnson, the senior from Grand Prairie, Texas, pulls in his 25th career touchdown pass. Now, the record is held by a couple of guys who played in the National Football League. Howard Twilley, Steve Largent, they both have 32.
So, yeah, two legendary names in Tulsa football. And head coach Todd Graham, very happy that his team now back in the lead at 42-38 with 8:15 left to go. But you know the way this game's gone, Mike, that's not it.
Dwayne Harris, the deep man, to receive the kick. Three times last year he returned kicks for touchdowns. And that is a single season and ECU record. And Fitzpatrick ready to kick off again for Tulsa. We still have 8 minutes and 15 seconds to go here in the ball game. And they're trying to keep it away from Johnson, or Harris rather, and it's a short kick down to the 25-yard line. And it's pulled in by number 87 again, Zico Pasut out of Ardrey-Kell High School in Charlotte gets his second return. There's the numbers comparing the two quarterbacks here today.
Well, two terrific days. You know, Dominic Davis making his debut for the Pirates, 267 yards, three touchdowns, and one interception. But Kenny, four touchdowns on 340 yards on 24 completions. He's done a nice job running the football, running the offense, and both guys have done an excellent job in their decision-making. I really like the play of both quarterbacks, and both of them aren't finished yet because there's a lot of football left with 8-11 in this game.
Pirates, they've won 11 of the last 12 overall in Conference USA competition. Lost last year at SMU, 28-21. Right now, they trail again 42-38. So they keep it on the ground up to the 40-yard line. It's Jonathan Williams. He nears the 100-yard game. Trent Wilkins making the stop. He's had one 100-yard game in his career, which is almost a shame. He is so talented. Harris, and he has nowhere to go. Good coverage coming up in press coverage by John Flanders.
One of those experienced secondary players for Tulsa on the corner. Just great recognition. Just a quick play outside to the playmaker Harris, and Flanders all over the football.
I guess it really wasn't press coverage, but he didn't give him a whole lot of room.
No, he didn't. Now third and very short for the Pirates, Mike.
And Jonathan Williams and Dominique Davis muff the snap, or actually the exchange, I should say, and Williams jumps on it, but that's going to bring up a fourth down now because they didn't pick up the first.
I'm not sure if Williams ever got this football in his belly. Tried to take a look like it hit him on the arm. It hit him on the right forearm, on the elbow, and Williams never had the football in his belly. As a quarterback, sometimes you take that for granted, but Davis has to look that football in, stick it in there, because it was less than a yard to go on third down.
Cody Wilson is the player down. Wilson, the gray shirt freshman out of Broken Arrow, Oklahoma, missed 2.5 weeks of spring ball last year because of an injury. So Todd Graham, in his fourth year, 46 records broken. So what do you do if you're Ruffin McNeil now? First game, I mean, you give up the football in the way Tulsa's been moving it. But then again, if you don't get the first down here, that's a short field.
You're going to give him instant field position, and I don't think you want to do that. I think that, you know, if you're going to go for it, let's think about what we want to do. Lincoln Riley's done an excellent job of calling the plays for this offense and for his head coach, Ruffin McNeil. And if you're going to go for it, you want to put the ball in your playmaker's hands, and that's either quarterback Davis, running back Williams, or Harris or Lewis on the outside.
Ruffin McNeil said three things he wanted to develop in camp: develop leadership, depth, and develop a personality. The first two probably were developed, but it's going to take a few games to develop the personality, I would think.
Well, they're developing a way to make this scoreboard light up right now, and they have to continue to try to gamble on fourth down.
They're going for it, fourth and three. Down in the ball game, Davis looking. He's going to go deep to a crossing receiver, and did it touch the field or is it complete? That's Joe Womack, the junior from Jacksonville. They're going to call it a completed ball and a first down for East Carolina.
Well, Mike, just as on the previous series, Kenny was able to move around and keep the play alive. Dominique Davis does the same thing, and that looked like a pretty good throw and catch.
Wow, I think, well, it's under review, John.
Let's take another look, Mike. The ball was coming down. Does the receiver, Womack, get his hands underneath the football? It looked like he did.
Looks like he did a great job.
And then he cradles the football. So I think that they're going to keep this as it was called on the field, the reception. See if we can see the hands go underneath the football, Mike. I think they're gonna credit him with the catch.
They call it a catch. They need indisputable video evidence to overrule the play. What was it, Lincoln Riley saying that Joe Womack, not great at anything, but good at so many things. And did a great job of coming back to the ball and even a better job of cradling it there before hitting the turf.
Yeah, I think the coaching staff's going to reevaluate that comment and say he's pretty good when he has to leave his feet on fourth down and about 3 or 4 yards to go and make a big play. And that's what Joe Womack did on fourth down. You know, we talked about him earlier. He's the gym rat. He's the guy that outworks everybody, and he's a good vertical guy. And that time, he sells out around the 36-yard line right now for the biggest reception of the game.
The conference opener, the season opener here for ECU and Tulsa. As we take yet another look, and again, it looks like he got his hands underneath, and the ball did not touch the turf.
Yeah, that's a nice effort by quarterback, lineman, trying to keep that play alive and putting enough air underneath the football so Joe Womack can come from the far side of the field and make a diving reception.
Pirates winning the Conference USA Championship 2 years in a row.
Drilling on the field is confirmed. It's completed pass.
There's the call. You hear the roar of the crowd, and it's a first down, Pirates of ECU. I was going to say, they won the Conference USA Championship, John, the last 2 years, but they never got that 10th win. Last year, they played Arkansas with Ryan Mallett in the bowl game, and they lost in overtime after missing 3 field goals in the last minute 2 of regulation and in the overtime. So they very well should have, or at least could have, beat Arkansas and finished with a 10-win season last year. There's another Muff with the exchange, and this time again it's Williams. So out of the shotgun, that's twice now that Dominique Davis and Williams have had some problems with the exchange.
Well, that's something they're going to have to shore up right away. I don't know if it's the relationship between quarterback and running back. It looked like Davis may have bobbled the shotgun snap from center, never got the football securely to give it to his running back cleanly on the play.
Still picked up 2, so 2nd and 8 now. 6:15 to go in the ball game. Davis turns, fires. Harris with the ball. Good balance. Harris, here he goes. He's out to the races. 5. Touchdown. Dwayne Harris with his 2nd touchdown reception of the afternoon.
Mike, another missed tackle by this Tulsa secondary. Dwayne Harris, just an easy, easy pitch and catch from quarterback to receiver. There's the missed tackle right there. And watch the burst and the acceleration. Actually, two missed tackles on the play. And Dwayne Harris knows how to find the end zone.
Unbelievable. The answer again. Barber on for the kick. And the kick is good. Lincoln Riley, the 27-year-old, his first game as the offensive coordinator, watching his team put 45 on the board with 6:05 to go. And Dominique Davis, his new quarterback, now with four touchdowns.
Unbelievable play. Just a simple turnout right here, bottom of your screen, and you're going to see one missed tackle, then the second missed tackle right there. Three white jerseys around. Nobody can bring Dwayne Harris down in the field. Davis, good recognition. He buys himself some time in the pocket, drifts back, makes an accurate throw, and then it's all over. The Dwayne Harris show is on, and watch him explode in the end zone, run by Lowell Rose for 6 points.
Well, before that catch, Harris had three grabs for 69 yards. Now keep in mind, he came into the ball game 104 yards shy of Troy Smith's all-time receiving record of 1,982 yards set back in 1998. But they're going to be tired after that many push-ups, huh?
I think they'll be happy with a three-point lead right now at 45-42 and a victory. They don't want to have to assume that push-up position any longer. And head coach Ruffin McNeil, for his first outing as head coach back at his alma mater, he looks a little worn out as well.
Well, when he was running the defense for Texas Tech, he's probably thinking, boy, was it always like this?
Yeah.
On the offensive side at Texas Tech. He had 579 yards against Michigan State in the bowl game. And well, what a shootout here with 6:05 to go. 45-42, and Tulsa will get the football back, and they've scored just about every time they touched it here in the second half.
Well, the question is now, can anybody on defense get as excited as their head coach to try to stop Tulsa on offense?
Boy, here's a very, very short kick trying to keep it away from Damaris Johnson, but they're going to get the football now at the 34-yard line. Genesis Cole with the catch. Don't forget, it all comes to a head tomorrow night, college football. Number 3, Boise State. Number 10, Virginia Tech. The All-State kickoff in the Capitol as part of Dick's Sporting Goods Kickoff Week on ESPN at 8 o'clock tomorrow night. College football available on TV, online, and on your phone. Go to ESPN.com for more information.
Well, once again, can Kenny bring his Tulsa offense back and answer with 6:05 left to go in this ballgame?
Well, he gets rid of it. Good job by Marquis Powell, the defensive end, coming in very quickly now. The last four possessions, 34, 68, 75, and 41-yard drives, all resulting in touchdowns.
And only one drive over eight, over five plays with an eight-yard play or an eight-play drive for 68 yards and a touchdown. So these plays have come fast and furious after this Tulsa offense has gotten on the field. They've done a nice job of making the points light up very quickly.
Young Pirate defense, now's the time to prove themselves with a stop. And Kenny dropped back to pass, saw lane open, gets up over the 40-yard line. Marquis Powell finally making the stop. Third down and two.
Well, this is the one dimension that Kenny's really been working at with offensive coordinator Chad Morris. Either throw it or tuck it and go. And he made a quick decision that time on second down to put his offensive team in a good third down situation with third and very short. As we take a look at the game summary, 9 lead changes and a lot of offense today.
Sunday afternoon, the rest of the Conference USA watching, thinking, wow, what a shootout. Uh-oh, there's the big guy, Charles Clay, and he's going to take it to the house. Unbelievable that he stepped out of bounds. It looks like they're going to call this one back at about the 32-yard line.
Great timing in the pass offense. The gamble doesn't pay off for Derek Blacknell. Let's see if we can see the foot. I don't know.
It's close.
It's very close. We may have to take another look at that because the big fella was high-stepping down the sidelines.
They're going to review it. And John Congemi, I know opening weekend's supposed to be fun, but I don't know if it's supposed to be this much fun. This is a blast.
I'm having a great time just being a fan and watching this game. I mean, the offensive fireworks have not stopped once they started, and East Carolina holds a three-point lead. But Charles Clay was trying to change that on that third down conversion.
That would have been his 32nd touchdown as we take another look at it. Indisputable video evidence. They did call him out of bounds.
Boy, I don't see it. Maybe the left foot. But the official was right there. He had a much better angle being on that sideline. So the ball looks like it's going to be placed around the 31-yard line. Let's take a look and see if the left foot goes out of bounds on the next step right there.
Right there, yep.
Maybe the heel just touches briefly, and you can see the official right there behind it. He has the best look. I think that's where they caught him out of bounds, around the 31.
David Blackman, the replay official, had an easy first half. He's been busy here in the second half. Kinney working with first down, looking for some running room. Now he brought down by a host of tacklers. Robert Jones, the defensive tackle. Or actually nose tackle, making the initial contact here on Kinney.
We haven't heard from Damaris Johnson, number three, the playmaker on the outside. He's had some nice special team plays, but right now might be a time to dial up his number.
Kinney finds his man open inside the 20-yard line, and Jameel Owens makes the grab again. Jameel Owens, he's 6'3", 228, so another big receiver for this Golden Hurricane team. Well, he had 3,400 yards, 45 touchdowns in high school, All-American. He was actually part of that Oklahoma team that played Florida for the national championship a couple of years ago.
Kinney on this drive, Mike, trying to make it five touchdowns. First and 10 inside the 15.
Inside, 4 minutes to go. They're going to keep it on the ground. Damaris Johnson, and look out. A.J. Johnson coming up to make the stop.
Well, they try to get it to the playmaker on an end around. They fake it inside, but Johnson comes up from that right end position, stays at home, and stays outside of Damaris Johnson. That's a nice play on first down and a big loss for Tulsa. Now, G.J. Kinney has to make a good decision, maybe flush the pocket, get outside, give him a run pass option.
Second and 19. Kinney fires right away. That's Johnson. Damaris Johnson spins inside the 10 down to about the 8-yard line. Blacknall in on the stop along with Emmanuel Davis. Damaris Johnson, we mentioned at the top of the broadcast, 16 career touchdowns, 13 receiving, one rushing, one on a kickoff return, one on a punt return, and he has a touchdown here this afternoon, so make that 17 career.
Well, he goes off on the biggest play of the game, third down. Look for a quarterback run, possibly on this play.
Third down, Kinney just takes off. He gets down inside the 5-yard line. All he had to do is get down to about the 4.
Not sure he got a great spot, though, Mike. He may be just short of this first down. Let's take another look. Inside running after the play fake. Kinney has to get down inside the 4. I take that back. Pretty good spot by the officials. But I think it's going to be about a half a ball short here, Mike.
Well, the marker was right at the 4. Looks like the tip of the ball is there. First down.
Oh, yeah, they give it to him.
First down, 2:36 to go. Down by 3.
That was a good effort, Mike, on the inside by the quarterback. Both quarterbacks have done an excellent job, not only throwing the football today, obviously, but running the football, making good decisions, knowing where the chains are to move those chains, and now they're in a first and goal position at the 4-yard line.
You said earlier in the game, Chad Morris, the new offensive coordinator, said that sometimes Kinney last year took off too soon. Doesn't seem to be doing that, picking his spots pretty well.
No, he's playing an excellent football game.
Alex Singleton in the backfield. They give it to Singleton, and he maybe picks up a yard down to the 3-yard line. Clock running, 2 minutes and 15 seconds to go.
Well, Mike, if you're Tulsa, you don't mind if you score on third down here, because, you know, you want to try to take that clock down. East Carolina has two timeouts, and you might see them, if Tulsa doesn't get in here on second down, maybe take one of those timeouts, because the time is ticking down now, and it's incredible how many yards have been gained by both of these teams. Over 1,000 yards today of offense.
And Tulsa at 575. Remember, they led the nation a couple of years ago at about 570 or almost. So in that regard, Todd Graham has to be pleased. Kinney pitches it out. And boy, nice job coming up from the defensive back spot was Bradley Jacobs.
That's just an old school tackle right there by Bradley Jacobs. He's a throwback in space. Just a terrific job on the freshman, Roberson, trying to get inside for a touchdown. And Bradley Jacobs up to the challenge.
ESPN2's coverage of Major League Baseball and the hunt for October continues tonight on Sunday Night Baseball as Buster Posey and the Giants take on that bitter National League West rival, Los Angeles Dodgers, led by Andre Ethier. Sunday Night Baseball, presented by Taco Bell, is part of the hunt for October, presented by Lee Jeans on ESPN2 and ESPN3.com, tonight at 8 Eastern. Boy, it's been a good one here from Greenville, North Carolina. Inside Dowdy Ficklin Stadium, minute 26 to go, 45-42. ECU, the two-time defending champions in Conference USA, holding on to the three-point lead. Again, we talk about the fact that Ruffin McNeil takes over a team that lost 9 defensive starters, 9 out of the 11 last year. What are those guys, if they're watching it back home, what are they thinking of this defense now?
Well, they're hoping they can hold on with a minute 26. Right now, they have a three-point advantage, and Todd Graham and Chad Moore is talking it over on the Tulsa sideline, trying to figure out what they can do on third and goal to try to get their quarterback or one of their playmakers into the end zone and retake the lead. You would have to think they went play action last time for an easy 6 points to the short side. You might want to take a look at that again.
Kinney rolls, fires, touchdown. Number 9, that's Charles Clay, and that's his 32nd.
And Mike, that was just too easy. They just sprint to the short side. They had success earlier in the game throwing to the short side. Kinney does an excellent job of just hitting the open receiver. And if you're East Carolina, that's just too easy.
You know, John, I held up on the call. I was waiting for the official because you saw his feet. He was awfully close.
He was.
To going out of bounds. So Kinney gets his 5th touchdown pass, and Kevin Fitzpatrick's on for the PAT. And with a minute 22 to go, it's a 4-point ball game. As Charles Clay gets his 32nd touchdown, and we take another look at, watch his feet. He's got the ball right there.
Yeah, he has that right foot in before the left foot hits out of bounds. And that's a good job of knowing where you are. Clay, a big fella at 6'3", 235. He's done it all for the Tulsa Golden Hurricane today. He's blocked. He's caught passes on the edge. He's run the football. 10 lead changes today.
Last 9 possessions. Now, Dominique Davis playing his first game since transferring out of Boston College to junior college last year. He's 4 touchdown passes. He's run for a touchdown. Now he can really play the hero.
That's right. And you mentioned this earlier, Mike. Whoever has the football last has the best opportunity of winning this football game. And head coach Ruffin McNeil right now hoping that his quarterback that he chose with the most experience coming into this first game, his first game as head coach, and the first game for Dominique Davis as a Pirate, can he win this football game? Can he lead this offense down with a minute 22 left to go?
There's number 17. That's Dwayne Harris. He had 3 touchdowns returned on kickoffs last year, a single season record. He has 37 kickoff returns for 1,000 yards with a long of 99 coming in, but I doubt if he will see the football. Well, he will see the football at the 22. Harris. Stutter step, still on his feet, over the 30 at about the 33-yard line, and that's where Davis and company will take over with a minute 15 to go in the ball game. Hold on to your seat. A minute 15 is a lot of time with these two offenses.
And they have one timeout remaining, so offensive coordinator Lincoln Riley trying to dial up something on first down. Pretty good field position for his quarterback. There are the numbers on Davis today, and there's the coordinator, Lincoln Riley, It's his birthday today. He turns 27. Nothing will make him happier than to see Davis take this down for six.
Here we go. Davis fires up the middle looking for Lewis. Lewis felt like he was pushed. No penalty flag down. And second and 10 now with a minute 12 to go.
Looked like Corey Doris, the defensive end for Tulsa, cramping up and in pain.
Doris starting 12 times as a true freshman last year, member of the Conference USA All-Freshman team, and a member of the first team preseason. Coach is telling us this young man is relentless. He never takes any play off. He just never stops at all. Practice or games, and, well, that could slow him down.
Doris is going to come in, Mike, on the left-hand side of the screen. He jumps up to try to bat the football down, but you can tell that stiff leg, he cramps up right away, and there, he's being attended to still on the field.
Looks like Dominic Davis came down on his right foot a little bit hard, too, or might have twisted it.
Well, plenty of time left for this Pirate offense. 1:12 left to go in this football game.
Ladies and gentlemen,
you get into a situation sometimes, Mike, where you want to make sure that you go down the field. Once it gets underneath a minute, you want to try to get your pass plays over 10 yards so the clock stops with the change of moving the chains.
You know, we looked at Tulsa's last four. Here's the Pirates now. Again, all resulting in touchdowns. So, you know, we talked about those nine defensive starters sitting at home watching this game for the Pirates from last year. But Todd Graham says, you know, we got to get back to playing defense. We got to get back to running the football. Well, they put 49 points on the board. I'm not so sure what he feels about his defense so far today.
Well, I would think that, you know, both sides have to go back and take a hard look. But right now, Todd Graham hoping his defense could come up with a big play.
Davis, good coverage, looking for Womack. Penalty flag down. The ball was thrown well over the head of number 82, Joe Womack, but he might have got a push there right at the last second.
Holding. 40 on the defense. 10-yard penalty.
Goes against Tanner Antle, the Will linebacker. And that has to help a little bit now with 67 seconds left on the clock.
Yeah, bottom of your screen, the hold was inside, away from where the pass was. And that's a big play because you're looking at third and 10. Now you've got a first and 10 with a minute 7 left to go.
And Davis, I think that was a quarterback draw from the get-go, but no running room there. Closed down by Finch, Darrell Finch.
Well, the Pirates have to get on the ball and get a play called because they don't want to waste too many of these valuable seconds.
48 seconds to go. This one's complete. Lewis inside Tulsa territory. You know, John, you look at that 2008 season for Todd Graham. Nine times they scored over 40, four times over 50, three times exceeded 60. They even put 77 on the board against UTEP. But now the big question is, with 49 on the board, can they stop ECU with 36 seconds? And there's going to be a timeout on the field, and it's going to be charged to the Pirates of East Carolina.
Yeah, it looked like Lance Lewis.
It's a 30-second timeout.
The receiver that caught the football almost should have went down because they wouldn't have had to waste the timeout. He was hurting on the far side. Coach McNeil trying to protect one of his players called a timeout, but in doing so, takes up their last timeout with 34 seconds left to go.
It's been a wild one here, 49-45. 2 years ago, the Golden Hurricane of Tulsa averaging about 47 points a game, just 29 last year. And now they have 49 on the board. But they have 36 seconds to play some defense and stop these Pirates of ECU from getting into the end zone.
Well, defensive coordinator Keith Patterson, he might not be happy, and head coach Todd Graham may not be happy in watching this film on the defensive side, but they'll be elated if they can keep Ruffin McNeil's Pirates out of the end zone right now. 36 seconds left to go, and the quarterback Davis at the controls.
Working from the 45, a first down. Using up some of that clock, and this one's going to be almost picked off. It was up there for grabs. Trent Wilkins came over, had his hands on it, but dropped it. So Dominic Davis lives to see another play.
We've seen Dominic Davis do this multiple times today, run and drift to his right and get away with throwing the football across his body. This time, he almost paid the cardinal sin of doing it one too many times. Wilkins drops the football playing center field.
29 seconds to go. And this one's complete. Harris, 35-yard line. He won't get out of bounds. Tulsa's going to make sure of that, but the officials stop the clock with 21 seconds.
The Pirates need to get on the ball after they set these chains for the first down. He may spike the football. Dominic Davis needs to get under center and be ready to spike the football to stop the clock.
Field goal does no good. There's the spike. 18 seconds to go. Talk about coaches telling their players you got to play for 60 minutes. Well, these guys are playing for 60 minutes, at least the offense.
They sure are. And right now, you might want to think about getting Justin Jones into the football game. He's the receiver at 6'8", and may be able to go up and get the football in a crowd, be able to make a play for the Pirates.
Todd Graham in his fourth year. 21-7 start in his first 2 years, the best start ever for a coach at Tulsa. 15 seconds. Womack had it and dropped it at the 20-yard line. If anything, he was in the middle of the field. But if anything, it stopped the clock with 13.
Boy, that's a nice throw and just a bad time to drop the football with 13 seconds left to go. Womack had a full head of steam, and he drops the football going across the middle around the 15-yard line. So now he has to get back, and Davis have to manufacture something. Got to get the football in the end zone.
Dominic Davis, and he throws this one up for grabs. Womack coming over, and it's out of bounds with just 5 seconds to go in Ruffin McNeil's first game as the head coach of the Pirates of East Carolina, where he played and started for 3 years back in the 70s for Pat Dye. You see some of the students back in the boneyard.
Well, Dominic Davis has no choice, Mike. He has to throw the football in the end zone. He's got his big play receiver on the outside, Dwayne Harris, and he's got the 6'8 Justin Jones right down here. They're going to try to throw a jump ball, and hopefully big number 84 or 17, Dwayne Harris, can go up and catch it.
5 seconds to go. Tulsa calls the timeout. You see Jones there, 6'8", 252-pounder out of Conyers, Georgia. Recruited by Skip Holtz, and Ruffin McNeil saying several times during our meeting what a great job Skip Holtz did. And he said, you know, you inherit a team that loses 9 defensive starters, but you know what? The skilled guys on the offense, well, we stepped right in, and we had some guys that could play this offense, and they proved that by putting 45 points on the board, maybe more with 5 seconds to go.
Well, we've seen how many players have caught footballs today wearing purple jerseys. He's done an excellent job of distributing those athletes around for Dominic Davis and his offensive coordinator, Lincoln Riley, putting him in positions to be productive.
East Carolina fans holding on after watching their team lose 34 Lettermen. That's the most of any school in FBS. The 6 starters returning, the fewest in Conference USA. Talk about a prevent defense, huh? They're back at the goal line now with 5 seconds to go. This is a fourth down play, so Davis has to make it good. Ball's up in the air. It's going to the end zone. It's batted down. Is it pulled in?
The big fella.
Justin Jones, you called it. The 6'8", 252-pounder. Final play of the ball game. Dominic Davis throws his 5th touchdown pass of the afternoon to the biggest receiver he's had in a while.
Just an unbelievable play, and that's a great job of going up and getting the football at his highest point. Justin Jones goes at 6'8", and watch him go up and get the football, out-rebound everyone in a white jersey for 6 points in the game winner.
Now they dropped the flag, but there is no time remaining on the clock. So many people were on the field, so the officials dropped some yellow laundry. But again, no time left on the clock. East Carolina with a two-point lead and a two-point victory, 51-49.
Mike, just an excellent job of wanting the football more than anybody else. Justin Jones, he's a special player. That's what Lincoln Riley, the offensive coordinator, talked about him, his head coach, Ruffin McNeil. They talked about he's as good as he wants to be. He wanted to be great on this play.
Yeah, Lincoln Riley saying, you know, he's so young, a redshirt freshman, he has no idea how good he can be. But again, keep in mind, recruited by Skip Holtz as a tight end, 6'8", 252. They come in with a Texas Tech-type spread offense, and he's thinking, geez, do I transfer? Do I play defensive tackle? Do I play offensive tackle? Let me play wide receiver because I like to score touchdowns, and there's none bigger in his life than that one right there. Now, the play is under official review. And Todd Graham has his entire team still over on the sidelines. And Ruffin McNeil trying to get an explanation.
After review, drilling on the field is confirmed it's a touchdown.
Well, they wanted to make sure, so they went upstairs to David Blackman.
The try needs to be made. So we will have the try down. East Carolina. 15 yards for excessive celebration. The try will be from the 17-yard line.
Well, East Carolina, Mike, just should take a knee here, and the game's over.
No time on the clock. 51-49. And if they don't take a knee, this is kind of an effort in fruition, isn't it?
Well, the big play of the game was already made, and Justin Jones, who be one happy person, and I know head coach Ruffin McNeil, he might be sweating, but I think he may be crying as well.
Todd Graham, a disappointing loss to open up the 2010 season. His quarterback, G.J. Kinney, 5 touchdown passes. Dominique Davis, 5 touchdown passes. Final score, there it is, 51-49. Ruffin McNeil gets a victory. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For John Kajemi and our entire ESPN crew, Mike Gleason saying so long from Greenville, North Carolina. Coming up next, Mac Tools, NHRA, U.S. Nationals qualifying from Indianapolis, Indiana.